Welcome to the historic Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand for One Friday Fights. Hello, I'm Mitch Shilson. That is the former One Flyweight contender Gianni Suba, and we are back in Lumpinee.
Mitch, so many legends have walked through the stadium. Samkor, Saenchai, Rotang, and tonight these fighters are looking to follow in the footsteps of giants.
Yes, and we have got a stacked card headlined by this Catchweight Muay Thai contest. Revo, Sommai from Thailand taking on Furkan, Karabag of Turkey.
This is a matchup I've been waiting for all week. Revo Sommai is all action. He comes forward with dangerous punches and elbows, and tonight he takes on a very dangerous Furkan Karabag. In these 4 ounce gloves, this style matches his style so well. Strong hands, chopping leg kicks, and body shots. This is a fantastic matchup.
That's the main event, but we have a stacked card ahead for you tonight. I cannot wait for this flyweight mixed martial arts contest as Fritz Bogdan takes on Nurmohamed Adam Konov. That's one to watch. Also, pay attention to the catchweight Muay Thai contest between Hannah Brady and Claire Ramkin. Gonna be a firefight. But kicking us off in atom weight mixed martial arts, we have Shihiro Sawada taking on Sanaz Faryaz Manesh in global rules atom weight mixed martial arts. We've got 3 5-minute rounds. The bout is judged as a whole, not round by round. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent, perfectly legal. No spiking or throws on the head, neck, or spine. Let's kick off One Friday Fights.
From the blue corner, Sanaz Faryaz Manesh.
Sanaz Faryaz Manesh, the undefeated eagle, is landed in One Championship. This amateur striker had a lot of fights in kickboxing and Muay Thai, but now she's crossed over into mixed martial arts, Gianni, and she is ready to make a name for herself. She's racked up 1-0, and she's ready to put on a show here tonight.
Bitch, Sanaz is not only a great kickboxer, her uncles were world champion wrestlers. Namatola Faryaz Manesh, Hunsmatola Faryaz Manesh, both world champions. So she grew up around the wrestling as well. She has that ability and she needs to rely on it, but tonight she tells us she wants to use that striking of hers.
Yeah, she thinks she has the advantage to really utilize that close boxing range. She wants to put hands on her opponent, close the distance, and get tight. Plans on stopping her opponent in the very first round with a nasty first round KO. So it'll be interesting. I'm thinking this is gonna hit the ground and she's gonna have to lean on that wrestling, Gianni.
Sanaz will have to manage her range very well. She cannot overcommit early because she'll end up on her back. Chihiro's an incredible wrestler. But Sanaz, if she manages footwork well, will land the strikes that will earn her the victory.
Yeah, Chihiro has been the talk of the town in Japan and is ready to make her entrance on One Friday Fights.
From the red corner, Chihiro Sawada!
Chihiro Sawada from the land of the rising sun. This young lady is highly decorated, Gianni. She's racked up wrestling championships. She's captured some mixed martial arts titles along her way. This lady is a high-level grappler, and she looks kind of familiar, doesn't she?
Yep. Dragon Kid Ryoto Sawada, that's her sister right there. They look similar, and I tell you what, they both have the tenacity when it comes to the ground. Chihiro, though, like you said, the current Shooto Women's Champion. You see the name on the shirt there, the very famous gym. All the Japanese women's legends have come out of that gym. Megumi Fuji, Ayaka Hamazaki, and they have guided her through this journey. She has been able to develop a striking game, a more well-rounded game to add to that dangerous wrestling style, Mitch.
Yeah, you talked about her striking, and like her brother, she comes from a karate background as well. I saw her this morning in the gym, and she was going through some kata and some breathing exercises, so she really has that traditional martial arts feel that she's bringing into this mixed martial arts contest. She says she likes the ring, she enjoys the dimensions of it, so she's ready to really put a halt to Sanaz's, you know, hype going on and really make a name for herself here tonight. So let's get it underway. We got two undefeated atomweights in the ring right now.
Welcome to One Friday Fights. We begin with 3 5-minute rounds of atomweight MMA live from the legendary Lumpinee Boxing Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Bayzat Warrior Academy, representing Iran, Sanaz Ego Fayazmanesh. And introducing her opponent, out of the red corner, she is a Shooto champion, training out of AACC, representing Japan, Chihiro Sawada.
Understand the rules. Let's keep this clean, keep it active. Obey my instructions at all times. Touch gloves if you want, back to your corners. Touch gloves, back to your corners, please. Judge, judge, judge. Time, ready, ready, let's go!
Chihiro Sawada closing that distance in that southpaw stance, looking to touch Sanaz with that left hand. Ooh, nice little duck under him in the double leg.
That was what we talked about. She cannot overcommit, and she does that. Chihiro ducks underneath, gets that double leg.
Beautiful timing on that takedown. Right now, she's in the guard of Sanaz, and Sanaz looks to be controlling posture. Got the feet on the hips, throwing the legs up, looking for an arm bar.
Good angle here, but you see Sawada steps over. She's in no danger. He's gonna pull out that arm. Might take Fayazmanesh's back.
Fayazmanesh trying to scramble around.
Heads up.
Trying to dig for the legs. Oh, knees to the head of the grounded opponent. Perfectly legal under the global rule set. And it looks like Sawada's gonna try to settle down into side control here. Sanaz might be trying to create a little bit of space, but might not have the room.
Watch the back of the head. Watch the back of the head.
Referee Mohammed Sulaiman warning her to watch the back of the head as Sawadas tries to settle into her position, and she does just that in the side control.
Sawadas doing good work there with the knees to the head from side control, lifting up the knee and dropping it straight down. But you see, she's trying to pressure herself here, try to advance position. Sanaz needs to keep her arms in tight, and Sawada has been looking to isolate one of his arms.
Sanaz is trying to go for a possible triangle. She's trying to throw those legs up to capture the head. I don't know if she's going for a scissors lock or if she's trying to go for an inverted triangle, but she's trying from the bottom here. But Sawada is really strong on top and doing a good job of defending that near leg of Sanaz as she's trying to work it inside to get back into guard.
Yeah, Sanaz needs to try to get the knees to the middle, try to create some frame so she can push up. Because at the moment, it is all Sawada. Looking to bump, might get that arm bar.
Oh, Sanaz trying to peel off the legs. She might have a little bit of space, but Sawada might be able to adjust, but it looks like Sanaz is able to sneak out the back and easily steps over, almost into three-quarter mount here.
Good transition, yeah, good transition there by Sawada to stay on top. Attacked the arm bar, couldn't get it, came back right into this dominant side control.
Yeah, I think Sawada's looking to crucifix that side, or she might be stepping over into mount now. Easily takes mount of Sanaz, and this is a bad spot.
Bad spot, she's gonna attack the arm again. This time much, much deeper. This could be it.
Let's see if Fayazmanesh can work some more of that Houdini magic as she tries to escape. She's tough though, she's tough, Iony, she's hanging in there. She uses her legs quite well. Right now she has a possible inverted triangle. If she can pull that heel down and possibly trap that arm right there. But Sawada
shakes it off, pops right up.
No.
Again, passes there. She likes this dominant position on top. Puts that knee through the middle. She's going to posture up and land some bombs here.
Really's able to cut through the guard, utilizes her legs well. Looks like she might be trying to go knee on belly. Sanaz is going to give up her back.
I'd like to see her try different options, because every time she gets to the side control position, she's looking to roll to that arm bar. Good wrist control there, trapping the arm of Fayez Manesh.
Ooh, and she steps over to take the back. That was slick. The right arm of Sanez is trapped up against her body. Let's see if Sawada-san can follow in her brother's footsteps and go after that rear naked choke. Dragon Boy loves it.
Both hooks in, it's flattened out.
I think Dragon Girl is looking for one too, but she might choose to pound her way to victory. Cradle in the head, ground and pound.
This is a much better option because the two attempts of the armbar has rolled her position, but she's going to go for it again.
Yeah, basically, Fayez Manesh is gift wrapping that armbar. She's just like, here you go, take it home for Christmas. There it is again. Let's see if Sawada can sync up this armbar. It's almost like Fayez Manesh is okay to give up that position because she knows she can scramble out of it. But she might be
blocked. This is much, much tighter.
Oh, no, the arm went past the hip point right there, and Fayez Manesh might be able to slide out that arm and last out the round, Gianni.
Yeah, generally, women have that double jointed in the elbow, so it's much, much harder to finish the armbar. Again, Fayez Manesh pops away out of that armbar, but all offense here in the first round from Chihiro Sawada.
Fayez Manesh is going for that inverted triangle. She's trying to pull the foot down to lock in that triangle.
Stop!
There goes. Entertaining first round there, Gianni. Got to see the dominance of Sawada on top. Great wrestling. High-level grappling, was able to control those positions, but Fayez Manesh was in there the entire time defending the submissions.
Yeah, but she cannot put herself in this position again. Overcommitted in the very first exchange, and it was just dominance by Sawada. Armbar attempt after armbar attempt. But like you said, Sanaz was just so tough, able to tough through these positions and pull her elbow out from danger. But the top control and the submission attempts. Sawada was apparent. First round, I'd say, all Sawada.
Go, corner out, please. Out, please. Let's go.
I think
out,
a lot
please.
Of our viewers would agree in your assumption there that it was all Sawada. Let's see if Sawada chooses to exchange a little
bit
and utilize that boxing she's been working on, or is she going to shoot right in there and test the takedown defense of Fayez Manesh right away? Where the first round started, and that's pretty much where it ended, Gianni.
Yeah, Fayez Manesh was just a little too heavy on her feet.
What's this, a buggy choke? What's she trying to do here?
I think she's throwing up her legs just to create a little barrier, but again, it's all Sawada moves right to mount, trying to isolate the arm again.
She's going into S mount, she's staying a little bit tighter, securing her position. Wants to get that position before the submission attempt. Oh, going for a far side Americana. That's it.
Great adjustment by Chihiro Sawada. Okay. Was not able to get the armbar. And in the second round, went to the Americana instead. And earned herself a second round victory.
Yeah, that was a slick little transition right there. It looked like she was attempting to go for the armbar right here. Had full S mount in control, right? And then a nice little read, right, falls in. Oh, that must have been a beautiful, that must have been the corner right there saying, hey, if the arm bar is not there, attack that far side arm and lock up that Americana.
There you go, that catches that wrist, torques that shoulder. But as my edge has to tap. That's the double leg in the first round. Gets in, reaps, and hooks the leg. Beautiful takedown there by Chihiro Sawada. Americana locked there, just so much torque on the elbow and the shoulder. Sanash, no choice but to tap. Great work from the young lady from Japan.
and gentlemen, after 53 seconds in the second round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner by way of Americana, Chihiro Sawada!
Chihiro Sawada gets the second round submission here to open the show. Non-stop takedowns, great top control, multiple armbar submission attempts, and finally gets the Americana in the second round. What a big victory for Chihiro Sawada. A lot of exciting matchups for her coming up.
Yeah, extends her record to 4-0, remains undefeated, and look for big things from Chihiro Sawada. But moving along to a catchweight Muay Thai contest. This was one to watch. I'm excited about this one. We're gonna go catchweight Muay Thai, Hannah Brady taking on Claire Rankin. We're gonna go global rules Muay Thai in this one. That's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. Three knockdowns in a round, that equals a TKO. No throws or grappling in Muay Thai.
From the blue corner, Claire Rankin!
From the hair, exemplifying the street fighter. This Scottish striker is right-handed, packs big power, really comes to put on a show. Now, Gianni, she's trained out there at Phuket Top Team. You've spent time there. Tell us a little bit about it.
I spent a lot of time at Phuket Top Team. You see Krun Nguyen there in the corner of Claire Rankin. Phuket Top Team is such an incredible gym. They have at the helm as well, Lertzilla, Chatan Wanglek, running the Thai program. And what they do so well over there, Phuket Top Team, is they cap the attendance, so all the students get that attention from the coaches. So Boyd has really done a good job over there. But Claire Rankin, all her fights have been in Thailand. She has fought the very best there is to fight. She tells us that she wants to expose Hannah Brady. She wants to show her experience in this fight. She says Hannah's one-dimensional, only comes forward. Claire wants to use her angles and use her sharp elbows to damage.
From the red corner, Hannah Brady!
The problem, Hannah Brady has landed in one championship. Now this British striker is strong with the knees and just basically overwhelms her opponents by putting it on them right from jump. Wants to utilize those hands, wants to close the distance and work inside the clinch. And she was also telling us about a kickboxing style that she wants to showcase here tonight.
You want to talk about a great matchup? I guarantee these two will just go in there and train. Hannah Brady, like you said, strong hands, but she's very comfortable in the clinch with her knees and her elbows. She has been training with John Pop and Leeds and Leon Capmonto. So expect her to be very well versed in the clinch as well. Like you said, the first round, Hannah wants to use that kickboxing style. She doesn't want to overcommit and get cut with elbows. Great matchup here. Expect these two to stand in the middle and trade, Mitch.
Yeah, you know, it was interesting to watch or to listen to the comparisons as they made them, right? They both said this is a perfect stylistic matchup for them, and they believe that they have the tools necessary to come out on top. So both ladies entering this contest, ultra high confidence. This is gonna be a good one.
Next, we have three-minute rounds of a 130-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Phuket Top Team, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 16-7. Representing Scotland, Claire Chun-Li Rankin. And introducing her opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Kiat Phuntip, UK, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 17-6. Representing the United Kingdom, Hannah Brady!
Face each other. Okay, you understand the rules? Fine, under Muay Thai rules. Then, if a knockdown, you must go neutral corner. Touch gloves, girls. Back to your corners, please. Judge! 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 Time! You ready? You ready? Fight!
Claire Rankin in the blue, Hannah Brady in the red. And a lot of feints coming early from Brady. Trying to slap Rankin. As Brady makes the nice little uppercut to a straight right cross combination. She's digging into the legs, but Rankin's starting to let those hands go.
Oh, wow. Beautiful combinations by both ladies. But the one thing they did talk about was the guard. They need to be careful here, not to trade too hard, because the openings with these small gloves are just so, so wide. A big left hook by Hannah.
Rankin trying to utilize long guard, but Brady is able to cut right through that guard with those hands. I like that wide angle hook. It's coming up from a different angle, and it's kind of surprising Rankin.
Yeah, she's kind of using that left hand as a diversion to land that big right hand.
Big looping hook as she goes through long guard, but Rankin digs to the body.
I like that nice body work by Claire, but Hannah just nonstop with her combinations.
Oh, big jab. You can see the strength from Brady as that jab just powers through, snapping the head back, and she follows it up with a nice little elbow.
Yep, Claire needs to find a way to not stand in front of Hannah, because right now she's wearing those shots.
And Brady is throwing those hands. It's like she's throwing axes. Big tomahawk elbows coming in. And she's trying to take the head off of Rankin, but Rankin is game. She is standing there in the pocket. Again, big elbow coming through the guard.
It's that upper elbow from the left side. That one rocked Rankin. Brady now going for it, following up with elbows and knees.
Big knee to the body. Again, Rankin's on the run as Brady starts to melt the Scottish fighter and lands two big right hands.
Woohoo! Hannah Brady makes quick work of Claire Rankin. And look at the work to celebrate. My, oh my, once she found the shot, she just did not stop.
Wow, look at Brady starting to pour it on. Been throwing over the top of the referee. Very unconventional in her target as she's throwing wide angle punches. Lands two beautiful right hands that just rock Rankin. Goes up top with the head kick. Rankin was on the run. Woo! Hannah Brady.
Yeah, Vince, she was just a little bit faster to the punch. Landed some beautiful elbows in through the guard that hurt Claire. And big victory for Hannah Brady as she picks up a first round knockout here at the iconic Lumpinee Stadium.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 2 minutes and 7 seconds in the first round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Hannah Brady!
Great work by Hannah Brady, picking up the first round knockout. Once she let it go, she did so much damage. Variety of strikes, jumping knees, head kicks, and the elbows. Right hand finishes her. Let's go to Mitch for the interview.
Hannah Brady, what a show you just put on. Right off the go, you were immediately throwing those big shots. Did you want to ease into this, or you just wanted to go?
I was going for the knockout first round. She wanted to come forward. I was going to give it to her. She got it.
Yeah, she did get it. Now, she said that you were a little bit hesitant. You weren't going to pull the trigger that fast, but you wanted to go for the knockout, get that first round finish?
Yeah, but I wanted to go with the hands and low kick, so that's what I did.
Yeah, this is a wide-open division for you. What do you want next? I know you got a lot on your mind. What's next for...
I'll be watching the Thai girl and Iony later. I'm fighting Iony in 5 weeks, so maybe the Thai.
Yeah, that's going to be a fun fight. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for your winner, Hannah Brady!
Hannah Brady picks up the first round knockout. What a victory for Hannah Brady. Incredible action here. The West has Madison Square Garden. And in the East, we have Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. Don't go anywhere. Next, we have Temelan Bekmurtayev versus Dit Duang Lek Tidit Gao Gao.
Problems are solving. I run through the money, the pressure be calling. Left on my blessings, I feel like I'm falling. The birdie is back, tell me I'm garbage. I'm going through something, that's why I ain't calling. Phone in progression, it's all that I wanted. The phone in affection, I summon and dub it. Cause I got problems on problems on problems on problems on problems on problems. I solve them. I run through the money, the pressure be calling. Left on my blessings, I feel like I'm falling. The birdie is back, tell me I'm garbage. I'm going.
Welcome back to the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. We're off to a great start, but we still got a lot more coming your way. Coming up next is a catchweight Muay Thai contest as Dechapan Tidit Gao Gao takes on Temelan Bekmurtayev. We're gonna go catchweight Muay Thai in this one. There's three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. Three knockdowns in a round, that equals a TKO. No throws or grappling in this one.
From the blue corner, Temelan Bekmurtayev.
Defeated phenomenon. I've been waiting for him for a long time, Gianni. He might only be 6-0 as a pro, but this cat has over 300 amateur fights, and he has been getting the rub from that man right there, Aliveri Ramazanov. He's surrounded by greatness out there at Mirzatuz Gym. This is going to be one to watch.
Rich, this kid is a five-time Russian kickboxing champion. He's been to the World Championships twice as well. His game plan is to go forward and use his hands. His favorite fighter, Iron Mike Zambidis. So you know what kind of fighter he's gonna be. He's tailored his game to his longtime idol. Big power in his hands, chop low kicks. This is an incredible matchup for him in the small glove pitch. That power will carry over.
Yeah.
And he takes on
Yeah, he said he focused a lot on his boxing, wants to apply that forward pressure, and he wants to attack first. But against Dead Duan Leg, whoo!
From the red corner, Dead Duan Leg Tded99!
At just 20 years old, he's had like 150 fights, and he's fought some very high-level guys. But he's really starting to put things together, Gianni. He's coming off a big win where he won the Road to One Thailand Championship. He likes these small gloves, and he is ready to put it on tonight.
Vince, that experience that you talked about, that is what Dechapan believes will be the difference maker in this matchup. He knows Tamerlan will look to come in and hurt him on the feet with hands and those unorthodox kicks. So the strategy for Dechapan will be to get into the clinching range and negate the punches of Tamerlan. He doesn't fight on the retreat, and he doesn't step in too wild. I'm really excited to see this kid shine tonight.
Yeah, Dechapan says he wants to eliminate that space so that his opponent, Tamerlan, is not able to utilize that space. So expect Dechapan to close that distance and try to throw those hands. This could be a really good matchup to watch because both these guys are ready to come forward.
And now we have 3 3-minute rounds of a 138-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Team Mediza 2, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 6-0. Representing Russia, Tamerlan Bekmirzaev. And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, he is the Road to One Thailand champion, training out of Tded99 Cao Cao. Representing Thailand, Dead Duong Lek Tded99 Cao Cao.
Tamerlan in the green and black shorts, Dead Duan Lek in the white. They trade kicks early, Gianni.
Yeah, Tamerlan needs to be careful. He doesn't want to trade kicks here with Dead Duan Lek.
I like how Timberland's coming forward, throwing those inside leg kicks and hand combinations. Really trying to walk down Dead Duan Lek.
See all the fighters out of that Medizatu team like to switch their stances and look for these dynamic hooks around the guard.
Yeah, we get to see a lot of that coming from Ramazanov, who's in the corner of Tamerlan. And just have a very imposing style, the way they come forward. It's hard to get a read on them because they're constantly changing stances. And you can see Timberland's trying to put that pressure on Dead Duan Lek as Dead Duan Lek's getting backed up.
And Dead Duan Lek, oh, nice. Left hand by Bekmirzaev.
Bekmirzaev lands a clean left hand on the entry into that clinch. Dead Duan Lek's having a hard time pulling the trigger.
A little bit gun shy at the moment. I like to see him throw some teeps through the middle, some left kicks just to throw off the rhythm of Bekmirzaev. Because at the moment, he's waiting. Bekmirzaev is getting first.
I like the way Bekmirzaev is putting those combinations together with the low kicks.
If I like that, throw the kicks, teeth down the middle. But Bekmirzaev, as you can tell, is looking to counter every time Dead Duan Lek kicks. Bekmirzaev throws a spinning back kick.
Oh, beautifully timed right hand by Dead Duan Lek to kick catch. Furkan Mirzaev mid spin and lands another clean right hand as well.
That's the risk with these big moves, Mitch. The spinning back fist, the spinning back kick, that it leaves you open. The Kongklai is looking to capitalize on that.
He closes distance remarkably well. We talked about on the walk, him reducing that space. And he really times that well when he sees Burkman Mirzaev start to spin. But we just got to see Burkman Mirzaev set that up a little bit.
But I like the volume. I like the volume of Big Mirzaev. He's not letting Big Gauntlet get comfortable. And every time he's in there, he's throwing.
Yeah, really important for Dechapan to circle out immediately once Big Mirzaev starts to go, because those are some heavy shots that he's throwing early on.
Good clinch work, but Big Gauntlet ties up Kevlar. Combination by Temerlan to end the round. Good start, a lot of combinations from Temerlan. Dechapan with some success. Here you go, left kick to the hands. Right kick over there. But you see, Temerlan just kept coming at him. Did not stop throwing the combinations. There's a spinning back fist. I say at the moment, it's the volume of Temerlan that's the difference. Dechapan had his moments, just did not throw enough. I think Temerlan ahead of the cards.
Yeah, Temerlan really pushes forward. When he gets that space to throw those combinations and he has Dechapan moving backwards, he can really unload, but Dechapan needs to find a way to close that space down, pick his shots carefully, and then start putting together combinations.
Beautiful counter to that left kick.
Yeah, that's the kind of combination that Mirzaev needs to start unloading on. It's a great job when he's in space of throwing those leg kicks with the hand combinations.
The crowd here at Lumpinee Stadium loving the work from Dechapan.
Dechapan received the loudest pop of the night so far. Nice little check landed by Mirzaev as Dechapan lands a clean jab.
Like that from Dechapan. He's looking for the jab now, not just waiting for the kicks. He is starting first.
Nice. See,
that will disrupt the rhythm of Bekmuzayev.
Yeah, those center channel weapons are working really well at the moment. He's got to keep his guard nice and tight, not allow those hands to get through.
Oh!
Big head kick by Dechapan.
This is much, much better from Dechapan. Tidak Kalkal, but Bekmuzayev still in the game. Right hand by Dechapan. Adjustment for Dechapan. He's leading now with the jab, being first, and then kicking Mirzaev on the way out. Look at that, leading with the 1-2, but now Mirzaev on the counter. Yeah, nice body kick.
Nice timing on the second body kick. First one didn't land, but the second one got through. Good head movement by Mirzaev as Dechapan got some body kicks.
He is picking up the volume in the second round, Mitch. Mirzaev seems to slow down a little bit.
Yeah, he really came out guns a-blazing in that first round. Second round, he might just take his foot off the gas just a bit to get ready for a heavy third.
And the kicking of Dechapan going right to the body, left to the body, jabbing him, just disrupting that punching rhythm of Bekmuzayev. And again with the left kick, and ties up, knee off the clinch. And Bekmuzayev again just comes non-stop forward.
Beautiful defense. Great covers up. Doesn't take a lot of damage when Bekmuzayev is starting to come forward.
You see the great game plan of Dechapan unfolding. Kicking, tying up, and going to the knees. Much better out for Dechapan Tidak Kalkal.
He told us he wanted to use his brain. He wanted to utilize that head as not just,
defense, but also to kind of figure out his opponent and choose his shots carefully. And as the match evolves, he's starting to show more and more of his strategy. And we're starting to see that as the match goes on. Beautiful head kick as he goes shin to chin.
But Temuzayev, every time he walked forward, was still unloading with the combinations. But story of the second round, Dechapan leading with the hands, kicking, throwing up that punching ability of Temuzayev. Bekmuzayev, another shot at that head kick. And it was just a volume of Dechapan in that second round, going left, right, middle, throwing off the rhythm of Temuzayev. Bekmuzayev. Might be one apiece going into the third round, Mitch.
Yeah, Gianni, I gotta agree with you there. I think we're looking at one round apiece, so this third round is really important. I wonder if Temuzayev Bekmuzayev tried to take his foot off the gas just to make sure he had enough in the tank to really start to turn it on in this third and final round. Dechapan looks fired up, ready to go as the third round gets started. Ooh, nice straight right hand to the inside leg kick by Bekmuzayev as Dechapan looking to answer back. Beautiful interrupting roundhouse kick to the body. Jabs looking to interrupt the forward pressure coming from Timurlan Bekmuzayev.
And Dechapan is reading the action well down the third. That was a big body shot. Referee breaks up the clinch. Oh. Close, close. Fight here coming into the third round.
Yeah, Dechapan seemed to change his right kick, that left kick, and it's starting to land heavily on the body. Nice little interrupting shots landed as Bekmuzayev enters into the clinch. Referee breaks them, separates them apart, and immediately Dechapan is right back in the face of Bekmuzayev. As Bekmuzayev lands a nice little inside leg kick to go for the spinning back fist.
And he does well when he doesn't wait. He's got to counter hard and counter fast. Exactly. Once he throws, he's got to go right away. Because right now, staying at the kicking range of Dechapan, he's not able to catch it.
Dechapan chooses to go to the body, lands a nice straight right to the solar plexus. Bekmuzayev follows up with a beautiful roundhouse kick right underneath the arm.
And that right hand pushed it back, Mitch.
Really sneaky little knees from Dechapan. As soon as he finds that right footing, where he's able to fire in those knees and scores with knees to the body. And this jam-packed crowd at Lumpinee Stadium is loving it. This stadium is used to seeing the best strikers in the world. And these two are putting on a show for this stadium right now.
Dechapan showing that clinch. Working that body of Bekmuzayev, the right hands! But Bekmuzayev coming forward.
Bekmuzayev not out of it, landing two huge right hands. Dechapan throws him to the canvas as he retreats as Bekmuzayev starts to push forward.
Those body shots are pushing Bekmuzayev back. Bekmuzayev still very dangerous in these small gloves. But Dechapan just nonstop. He sees Bekmuzayev pushing back. Can he put Bekmuzayev away?
Bekmuzayev spins to the ground, missing a massive spinning back fist, but Dechapan and these two are just trading big right hand.
Wow.
Dechapan landed a massive knee right at the bell. I believe Bekmuzayev lasted the entire fight, and that's not the end. I think he was saved by the bell. Look at that big left hook landed by Bekmuzayev. And it's almost like Bekmuzayev just crumbled from exhaustion as the bell rang.
I mean, this is why we come to Lumpinee Stadium, to see action like this. Dechapan in the third round put on a pace that had Bekmuzayev on the back foot. Bekmuzayev, though, did have some moments with some combinations off the break. There you go, a right hand there, left hook by Bekmuzayev. But that pace of Dechapan with the body clicks, the clinch work with the knees. Wow, what an incredible bout.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. Det Duong Lek.
In the second and third round, you saw Timberland almost wilt under that pressure. Well-deserved win at this iconic Lumpinee Stadium, Mitch.
That's the kind of strike you need to expect to see at Lumpinee Stadium as Dead Dwanlek celebrates in the center of the ring. What a performance. We still got a lot more coming your way. Coming up next, Alessandra Savicheva takes on Zeba Bano.
Submission the likes of which we've never seen before.
Right into the underneath, here's a heel hook.
Yep, and that's
a tap.
Submission.
That's a tap.
Sweet revenge for Alex Silva.
He goes Ashi Garami to the heel hook.
Protection.
That's quick, that's quick.
Oh, look at Mustafa falling into a triangle. Triangle finish over his BJJ black belt.
Derrida versus Big Dash for the middleweight championship of the world.
Derrida throws it up, right? Let's see. This is tight.
Oh, it is
tight. That's tight.
That's tight.
Vitaly's going to sleep.
He's out. He's out. He's out. 16-0. And he puts Big Dash to sleep.
Bantamweight Championship of the World!
Oh, big shot! Lineker's in trouble against the fence!
His cup has been shattered.
This fight has been declared a no contest.
With a score to settle, Bricio Andrade and John Lineker.
Legendary stadium. You come to watch great fights. You come to Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. It's been a great night so far, but I think things are just about to heat up. Coming up next in the women's strawweight division, Alessandra Savicheva taking on Zeba Bano in Global Rules MMA. Three five-minute rounds, bout judged in its entirety, not round by round. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent, legal.
From the blue corner, Zeba Bano!
She believes is to outstrike Alessandra her coach and fiance in the corner, the bull himself, tells us that Zeba Pando has the opening for that big overhand right. They think they can find that shot and put Alexandra away.
With most of her wins coming by ground and pound, I would have expected the opposite. I thought she'd want to take the Russian kickboxing champion, Savicheva, off her feet, put her on the ground and beat her up, but no. She really believes in her striking and wants to put on a performance of a lifetime here at this historic stadium, and now is her time to do that.
From the red corner, Alexandra Savicheva.
Alexandra Savicheva, the undefeated Russian superstar, is now in one championship. She's got a lot of accolades in kickboxing, Gianni, but this is mixed martial arts. And what do you like so much about Savicheva?
Bitch, 48-2 in kickboxing, 10-time Russian kickboxing champion. This young lady is so fast on the feet. She moves in and out really well, and she has that Kudo World Championship experience. Kudo is a Japanese martial arts where it's very similar to mixed martial arts. They have punches, kicks, and throws. So she's used to that punching and wrestling exchange, that transition. So much hype behind this woman, Alexandra Savicheva. And she told us she has been training in Thailand as well as Rocky Gym. So look for her to showcase her elbows and knees.
Yeah, she put in time over at Tiger Muay Thai in Phuket, Thailand, and got around a lot of high-level women and get to test her skills up against the very best. And for this fight, she says she wants to start fast and get that KO. She knows just what her opponent brings to the table, but believes she has all the solutions to this problem in front of her.
Next up, we have 3 5-minute rounds of women's strawweight MMA, presented to you by Monster Energy, Unleash the Beast. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, holding a mixed martial arts record of 6-1, representing India, Zeba, Fighting Queen Bano. Introducing her opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Rati Gym and Global Fight Gym, representing Russia, Alexandra Savicheva.
All right, come center, please. Athletes, come center, please. Center, please. We're here first, please. People understand the rules, all right? Let's keep this clean, keep it active. There'll be my instructions at all times. Touch glove if you want, and back to your corners, please. Back up. Judge. Judge,
Zeba Pano.
Judge, time, back up, please,
in
back
blue,
up.
Representing
ready,
India.
Ready, let's go.
Alexandra Savicheva in the red, representing Russia.
Alexandra's very good with that in and out footwork, just like that, she slides out the way. Zeba Pano, like you said, is a good wrestler, but she already showed some good hands in this one. Big left hook by Pano to start.
Savicheva's trying to come right down the middle with that jab two opening. Dechapan looks to be countering. She looks to be countering with that left hook. She's waiting for it.
Dechapan going wide, but Savicheva looking to come down the pipe.
That was a nice little counter off the leg kick. Dechapan's got to be scared, careful falling for these feints. She's biting on a lot of them.
Let's go, let's go.
You see Pano there with the big legs. That will give her that power, Mitch. Hurt Savicheva, but at the moment, Savicheva with some nice footwork.
We're starting to see Pano start to reach for the legs, reaching for the legs. She's trying to counter or catch, maybe to possibly go for a takedown. She's got to be careful because Savicheva likes to go low, and then start looking up top. So she might be sitting up in head kick here.
Yeah, Bono's looking to counter. Real heavy on the feet. You see Savicheva a little bit lighter. Ooh, like you said, oh, spinning back fist up the high kick. Nice by Savicheva.
Yeah, that was a nice little opening right there. Found a mark on the head of Bono. Hana needs to close that distance. She's playing right into that distance range management of Saricheva. There's a game with the head kick.
She's finding it because Hana is just staying there, but she's not really moving her feet. So Saricheva knows exactly where she is.
And as soon as Bono switches to orthodox, you start to see those leg kicks start to come from Saricheva. Right, there's a nice little two body kick. Saricheva Bono enters into the clinch. Good choice. Enter inside that clinch.
She gives Saricheva here a double underhook position.
Yeah, she's going for the head and arm. She might be trying.
It's got no holding. What the finish?
You know, Uchimata or Judo throw, but Saricheva takes her the other way and ends up in side control. Gotta be careful of the back of the head. Saricheva. Bono might be able to reverse this position with this headlock, but Saricheva easily just kind of manages her balance and sits there.
Wow.
Mount.
Bono's got to let go of that head because she's giving Saricheva this mount. All Saricheva needs to do is push up on the head of Bono and break that grip. And she's in full mount, dropping bombs on Bono.
Bono's trying to sneak her legs around the backside to create that space and keep the guard, but Saricheva very well controlled on top and just letting it go from mount.
Bono needs to shake her off, needs to do something, because right now Saricheva's dropping big, big elbows on her.
Saricheva's looking to pin down. Bono works her way out, but she gives up the rear naked choke.
This is a terrible position for Bono to be. Saricheva with one hook in.
Yeah, Bono has to kind of start pushing the legs out. She's got to start moving her hips rather than just trying to control the head posture. Saricheva lands a big shot to the back of the head there. It looks like the elbow. Just stoppage by referee Mohamed Sulaiman. As Alessandra Saricheva extends her undefeated record. It's a big performance and a nice stoppage victory.
Once she got her down, Saricheva just unloaded with elbows. And here, hooked right on the guard of Zebabano. Just unanswered shots. But it was the striking of Zebabano that sent, Alexander, that set this up. Nice footwork, moving in and out. And some good right hands that led to the takedown and the finish. Round and pound here again. Just unanswered shot here by Alexandra Saricheva. Picking up a first round TKO. Big victory for Alexandra Saricheva.
This match was presented to you by Monster Energy. Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 minutes and 39 seconds in the first round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner by way of technical knockout, Alexandra Saricheva!
Alexandra Saricheva adds another one to the mixed martial arts record. Showcase some nice footwork, that all-around style. Got the takedown, took the back, ground and pound to secure herself a first-round TKO victory here, Mitch.
Coming up next, Chris Magitan taking on Nurma Mohammed, Ahmed Kunal.
Smoking Joe! Oh! Oh, the big kibosh! Chicken!
hook to the body.
If you step the pace up,
I'm gonna come with you. That was the right hand that shut him down.
Oh, smack back.
Beating on the calf.
The West might have Madison Square Garden, but the East has Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. And Gianni, it's been an awesome night so far. Lots of stoppages, lots of finishes. But I think this one, the Fly Guys are in the building. Fritz Bagitan taking on Nur Mohammed Adam Kolnov in flyweight mixed martial arts. 3 5-minute rounds. The bout is judged in its entirety, not round by round. Knees to the head of a grounded opponent are legal. No spiking or throws on the head, neck, and spine.
From the blue corner, Nur Mohammed Adam Kolnov.
This striker is ready to make his debut on the biggest show on the planet. But speaking of shows, you can enjoy the best seats in the house this Saturday at 10 p.m. Eastern with the PR replay of One Friday Fights airs live on Meta Horizon Worlds. This guy is a lot of fun to watch. His Muay Thai career was very successful. I'm looking forward to him again in mixed martial arts, Gianni.
Bitch, Adam Kolnov not only has many Muay Thai fights to his name, but he has been training in Sambo since the age of 8 years old. So he's got that experience in the grappling department. Although his record doesn't show it, he wants to stand and train with Fritz because he believes he has the advantage on the boxing department. And he tells us if he can't finish Fritz, he does not discriminate. He's willing to take Fritz to the ground and says, hey, I might have some submissions up my sleeve.
You know, I think the submissions is a good game plan because you got to mix martial arts, man. You got to mix things up. And he says he gets good everywhere. So plan B is that takedown and submission. But on the feet, he plans to utilize those hands, go fast right away from the opening bell, utilize that slick Muay Thai style that he's got, and go forward and put hands on the Tornado Kid.
From the red corner, Fritz Bjorkton!
Fritz Bjorkton! Gianni, I'm pumped about this kid being here in One Championship. He's had a very successful career in both mixed martial arts and Muay Thai all over the Philippines. And look who he's got in his corner, his fiance, Denise Zawambawanga. But he wants to be more than just Denise's fiance. He's ready to make a name for himself tonight.
Fritz, I've known Fritz for about 9-10 years now. And I always remembered him as such a dynamic fighter. Incredible power in his hands. And he has that experience in the stand-up department, the national WBC Filipino champion, URCC Filipino champion. He is now making his world stage debut tonight against Adam Kolnov. Fritz took about a 4-year break away from mixed martial arts competition, but he has used that time well. He spent it on developing his wrestling, spent it on developing his jiu-jitsu, and he is here tonight to showcase that well-rounded style, bitch.
Yeah, man, I remember watching this guy go 3 rounds with tension, you know, so his stand-up game is legit. You speak about those 4 years
of inactivity in mixed martial arts, but he had 12 Muay Thai fights in the Philippines and Malaysia. He was all over the place putting in work on that stand-up. So this is going to be really interesting to watch this guy on the feet. He's got a 39-8-3 record in Muay Thai. And that WBC title that you spoke about, Gianni, whoo, this kid on the feet is a problem. He puts combinations together with power. This is going to be a really fun fight, and I'm excited to watch Fritz make his ONE Championship debut.
And now, we have 3 5-minute rounds of Flyweight MMA. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Team Medizatu, representing Uzbekistan, Nur Muhammad Adamkonov. And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of T-Rex MMA and Belton MMA, holding a mixed martial arts record of 4-1. Representing the Philippines, Fritz Kid Tornado Biogton!
Well, at the center of this, well, you don't understand the rules. Let's keep this clean to play. We have instructions at all times. Touch glove if you want, and then back to your corners, please.
Yes, sir.
All right, back to your corners.
Judge, time, ready?
Let's go!
Nur Muhammad Adamkonov in the green and black. Fritz Vahitan in the black. This highly anticipated flyweight matchup gets underway.
I'm interested to see who's gonna be the one to take that shot first. Both men just feeling out the range. They know the capability of each other. They stand in there. It's knockout range.
Really similar Muay Thai records on both these guys. I'm expecting just a striking bore as Fritz lands a big right hand as Adamkonov backs up.
Beautiful combination by Fritz. Right hands into the jumping knee, but Adamkonov here ties him up.
Adamkonov trying to turn into a grappler. This is plan B. Fritz landed that massive right hand. Adamkonov gets those double underhooks. It's a good position. He's strong in this position. Let's see what kind of takedown defense Fritz has.
Fritz needs to pummel that right hand in right now to get an underhook. But you see that grip of Adamkonov, so strong. That sambo background that we talked about, lots of upper body throws. Adamkonov trying to pick him off his feet and look to sweep him up to the side or the front. But at the moment, Fritz doing a good job. There he goes. Gets the underhook and turns.
Swim in to create a little of that separation. Now he's got a 50-50 pummel. Bogdan backs up. Adamkonov into the ropes. A lot of pressure coming from Kid Tornado early on.
Fritz with a grip there, trying to pinch him and turn him in. Both men just jostling here in this over-under position.
Into the tie.
Adamkonov. And that one was right on the cut. We had a really good view of it.
You want to continue?
Okay, continue. Ready to go? Just checking on Fritz. Which is all good. Let's get right back into it. Fritz was the one that was able to land the shot first in that first exchange with the right hand. Adamkonov, the ball is back pedaling. We're gonna land that lead left hook, looks like. But, ooh! They tie up again, it's 50-50. And it's Adamkonov with the body lock. He's looking to level chase to get that takedown, Mitch.
Trying to go after that leg. Good balance. Good use of the ropes. Adamkonov, as Fritz looks to rebound that right leg, but Adamkonov pulls that leg in and starts digging those underhooks.
Yep, that was not able to be completed because of that underhook pitch. The leverage of the underhook stopped Biekton from getting underneath the butt to finish the double leg. And at the moment, he's doing a good job of keeping Adamkonov on the ropes. And for him to try to break off here with some elbows. Hey, nice elbow by Fritz.
combination.
Thrown by Adam Knopf.
Ooh, touches him in the body and two left hooks.
Adam Knopf needs to clinch. He's wobbled. Prince is smelling the blood in the water. He goes to the body with a big right hook.
It's taking his time. But Adam Knopf heard and looked. Adam Knopf still a wobbly leg. Prince backs up it. I see that. He's looking to close the show here in the first round. Oh, right hand!
Lockdown is very patient. Look, he's moving around, picking his shots carefully. Knows that Abkhanov is hurt. He's not rushing anything. He has a nice, patient shot. I like to see him put together some combinations. Right now, he's used to just throw one shot at a time, but...
I like that he goes to the body first, Mitch. Goes to the body with the left, it comes over with the right. Again to the body.
There's a point to Adam Knopf saying, I got you again.
And this is what makes Prince so exciting to watch. He is a showman. Has Adam Knopf hurt you? Looking for the right hand. But Adam Knopf here. It's a good low. What a great matchup between these two flyweights. Prince Bangkok and Adam Knopf going to battle here.
Prince is having fun out there as the 10-second clapper goes. The time of flying knee as Adam Knopf comes in, but big right kick follows it up with that right hand. Adam Knopf was in some trouble, Gianni. Prince putting on a show here at Lumpinee Stadium. Whoo, there's that right hand, bobbled it.
Just kept that pressure going once he got there. This is the knee after that exchange and the elbow here. Big shot by Fritz. Body, left hook. This is a shot that had Adam Knopf on skates. Another 50-50 exchange, but it was Fritz that was able to get into the punching range first and land. Adam Knopf, although had his moments, it was Fritz that was able to land the harder, the more significant shots.
Yeah, he's economic with his shots. He's not wasting a lot of energy. Even when he has you hurt, he's picking clean punches. Very accurate. Fritz Yogtan putting on a show at Lumpinee Stadium. The kind of striking we're used to seeing, world-class level. Both these guys are looking to make a name for themselves here at this historic Lumpinee Stadium.
One thing we have to remember, Mitch, is has Adam Knopf recovered? Did Fritz let that opportunity slip by? Because he had him on the skates and could have finished him, but was very, very patient. Now Adam Knopf looks recovered coming into the second round.
Adam Knopf pushes forward, trying to close that distance. Nice right hand landed as they enter into the clinch. Looks like Yogtan's got two underhooks as he circles around, presses. Adam Knopf up against those ring ropes, reaches the outside legs. It looks like a possible rope grab could have prevented Adam Knopf. Ended up on his backside.
Yep, gets a stern warning there from referee Suleiman. But now Adam Knopf pushing Fritz against the rope, looking for a takedown of his own. Fritz was able to unleash the big elbow in the first round off this break. And he's looking for it again. They're going to control the bicep here. That gives him the space by that elbow.
Trying to frame.
Stop. Let's go. Let's pick it up.
Advantage, so he's able to lock up those arms to prevent that separation in those elbows as Fritz is staying light on his feet, looking again for that big right hand.
Oh, nice jab there by Adam Knopf lands. Big exchange here. Adam Knopf has seemed to settle now into this range. It looks much more comfortable. Fritz on the back foot instead of pushing forward.
They both like to close that distance so quick. They each get to throw one combination or a couple of strikes, and then you see him clinch and just kind of tango right there. Adam Knopf seems to have shaken out the cobwebs from those big right hands landed by Fritz early in the first round.
He's been able to land nice jabs. But Fritz, every time he closes that distance, lands something fast, something hard.
Closes really fast. He keeps his feet underneath. underneath him. Little micro movements on the footwork. Gets in there, lands that big right hand, and then he's gone.
This is why the flyweights are so exciting to watch. So much speed, so much technique. These two have the power to go with it as well. Nice stand switch there. Back step. Adam Kanap pops a right hand again. Fritz did unload a lot of heavy combinations in the first round, and adrenaline as well. This is his first time here in the one circle. Has that pressure, has the adrenaline kind of worn Fritz? Because at the moment, hasn't thrown a lot in the second round. Adam Kanap looks to be the lighter one on the feet.
Action left, action blue.
Left hook.
Fritz still taunting him. Still pointing at him every single chance he gets. He's not firing.
Yeah, but that's the same way,
but he's timing it.
That's the shot.
Still there.
That's the shot that did so much damage for him in the first round, that left to the body, that he followed up with the right hand. He's not throwing a lot of those at the moment.
Letting in the forward movement.
Yes, exactly.
We saw in the first,
exactly.
Right?
Is he taking a break? Is he catching his breath here? We don't know. Adam Kanap at the moment landed the better shots.
Woo! Got him. Adam Kanap is not on. Stable legs right now.
This is better. He needs to go at it. He cannot let Adam Kanap recover like he did in the first round. Hands low by Adam Kanap. Fritz could land a left over right there. Chooses to go to the body, though. Adam Kanap is hurt. His legs are gone. Fritz just needs one more shot to put him away.
Chooses to go to the liver yet again. Is Fritz Biaktan as he's backing up. Mohammed, Adam Kanap is going to throw some big air balls at Fritz as he closes the distance. Look at him put hands on
him. Ooh, that one hurt him, Fritz. You saw Adam Kanap winch up that body shot. Yeah, he's hurt. He's diving for a takedown. 10 seconds left. Fritz doing damage on the ground.
Got to be careful with the back of the head. Got to choose his shots carefully. Adam Kanap did a good job of saving again himself from near disaster.
Slow start for Fritz Biaktan, but once he landed that shot, he had Adam Kanap hurt. But Adam Kanap, the second round, had a lot more success with his jabs, staying on the outside. Fritz, all night long, has been able to land that left hook. That check hook there had Adam Kanap hurt, and Fritz just stores him. Left kick to the body. It was the left body shot, Fritz, that really, really damaged Adam Kanap. And the check hook up to the head rocked him again.
Looked like that one, that left hook, caught him on the temple, right? Didn't look like a clean shot, but it was just on the right spot, right behind the ear, and it just rocks your equilibrium. And you can see Adam Kanap couldn't get his feet up, beat him. And then Fritz Biaktan was able to pour that on and digging for that check left hook over and over again.
The crowd here at Lumpinee Stadium loving this flyweight mixed martial arts action.
I know you're biased to the flyweights, Gianni.
Oh, you know I gotta show him some love, bitch. Third and final round, Fritz Biaktan versus Adam Kanap Nurmuhammad. Back and forth so far, but it has been the power of Fritz Biaktan that has been the difference in this one.
Fritz getting back on that bicycle. Looks like he's regained the juice. Back in his footwork as Adam Kanap continues to push forward.
You're right, Mitch. He is very economic with his strikes. He doesn't throw a lot, but when he does, he hurts. I'd like to see him set it up, though, like you said. Maybe throw jabs, throw some leg kicks there. Get Adam kind of thinking, then go to the body with that left hook.
Yeah, you can tell Fritz has had a lot of knockouts, and he's got that knockout feeling. He's trying to get one here tonight. But Adam Kanap is tough, man. He's absorbed some big, big shots, but Fritz Prowse is still looking for that big KO finish. There, now he's trying to put the leg kicks together. As soon as Adam Prowse comes forward, start touching him with those leg kicks. Get a stationary target, it's a lot easier to hit.
But it's that stand-up experience, Mitch. Both of them have been in so many striking battles that they have been hurt before. They know how to recover, they know how to poker face it. Right now, Adam Kanam doing a great job of hiding it, and he's still hurt.
Had, you know, 44, so both these guys are high-level strikers. That was a beautiful timing on that low kick, right as he entered the pocket, touching with the leg kick, just scoring at this point. He's had some big moments. Referee Slump wants action. Come on, you gotta bring the firefights here in Lumpinee Stadium. That's what we expect. Referee Muhammad Sulaiman is telling these guys to get after it.
A lot of footwork right now, still staying in the outside of the range. Both guys trying to find the foot positioning to land the big bombs. Prince, they're here, weaving into possibly a left hook. Bang!
That like shot there. Like Tyson as he goes to the spinning back fist. Good movement from Adam Kanoff to get out of the way of that.
Nice 2-3 by Adam Kanoff. Chopping leg kick there by Prince.
See, those leg kicks score effectively for Prince, man. He's able to do damage with that. I'd see him put the hand combinations together, freeze Adam Kanoff, and then dig those leg kicks in because they're scoring at will.
Yeah, that's what he needs to do. Chop that leg exactly like you said, Mitch, and then look to throw the hands off the Adam Kanoff at the moment. Needs something big because Fritz is able to rock him in the first and second round, so you have to expect him. Oh, left hook again by Fritz to be up
right
on the
ground this time. It's right around the 2-minute mark of each round where Fritz looks to turn up the volume and get him out of there. Ooh. Both throwing the heat.
He closes that distance so fast. That's why I was so excited to watch Briggs, because he's so dynamic, closes that distance so well. And that showmanship. If he can't put him away, it's going to be huge, Mitch.
Yeah, I think Fritz is going to go back and look at this tape and realize he let a couple of golden moments slip through his fingers.
But we have to applaud Adam Kanoff. He's not going anywhere. He's showing that experience. He's in here, still trying to score these big shots.
That's true, but you gotta keep in mind that Adam Kanoff is straight out there. Maybe he's on Twitch today, but he's surrounded by some of the world's greatest strikers. So, that right hand is touching right at the back of the head, right at the back of the ear, right at the side of the ear.
Yeah, it's when he chooses to go. He just doesn't throw a lot. Few and far between are these big, big shots from Fritz. I like to more jabs, more chopping low kicks, and then go big bomb. Let's change the tempo, because at the moment, we just want slow, and explode.
Head movement, saw that jab coming. Fritz's eyes are sharp as he's walking down. Adam Kanoff shows in the right hand, goes to the body shot. Muhammad Sulaiman is digging into his pocket. Nothing good comes out of Sulaiman's pocket. As he shows the yellow card to both athletes. Wow, what do you think about that?
I mean, I can understand it. Referee Muhammad Sulaiman likes action, and both of them not giving it up, but now they go right into it. That was the motivation they needed to stand in there and bang!
Looks like Fritz caught him on the exchange. See, look at these combinations.
Oh! Almost in left hook! Puts him away! Fritz back down! Lands that left hook and finishes! Adam Kanoff! Wow!
Maybe something good does come out of the pocket of referee Muhammad Sulaiman. As Fritz Piazza turns up the heat and starches Nur Muhammad. Adam Kanoff with a massive shot. As Chris is breakdancing into a push-up. Look at that left hook. Spun his head around like the Exorcist. Boom! What a shot by Chris Piazzon as he's getting down inside the third ring.
I love it, Mitch. Once he decided to, Fritz just had that knockout power. Bang! Left hook, lights out. Adam Kanoff goes to sleep.
Fritz Backton with the third round knockout in the 9 seconds. Wow.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 4 minutes and 36 seconds in the third round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Fritz Backton!
Fritz Backton, kick tornado with a third round knockout in the 9 seconds. Look at the emotion. Such a big moment for the man, finally here in the world stage. Was able to land that left hook in the third round. He did so well in the first and second with the body shots that hurt Anakano. Let's go up to Vince Chilton for the interview.
My man, Fritz Backton, coming away with the last second KO. Referee Mohammed Sulaiman went into his pocket, gave you the yellow card. Was that the motivation that you needed?
Yes, actually, yes. I was like, no way. I need to buy my ticket back to Philippines. I said, no.
What a shot. Dude, he absorbed a lot of punishment in both rounds 1, 2, and you finally got him out of there in the 3. Were you surprised by how tough his chin was?
Oh, yes. Where's Adam? Adam, you're so tough. I really respect you as a fighter, so I expect that he's tough because he's a striker, so I definitely expect this kind of fight, but I didn't know, like, he can long last about 3 rounds. And then when the referee put the yellow card, I was like, oh no, I'm dead. I need to finish this fight.
Well, finish you did. Please, Lumpinee Stadium, give it up for your winner, Kid Tornado!
What an amazing matchup that was, and what a talent Fritz Backton is. So excited to have him here in this flyweight division. Started a little slow, but once he let the hands go, was able to pick up a highlight reel knockout of Adam Kama. Next week, we have a massive card for you. 1597, Lineker versus Andrade 2. And the co-main event, Taiwan versus Jamal Yusupov.
The reign of gold begins for Taiwan. He is once in a generation, and he's just getting started.
Oh, that's it!
Jamal Yusupov is taking out the biggest names in Muay Thai.
Taiwan versus Jamal Yusupov for the featherweight Muay Thai Championship of the World.
We have with us the undisputed featherweight Muay Thai world champion, Taiwan PK Saenchai. He's our co-main event next week, going up against a very dangerous Jamal Yusupov. What a matchup that's going to be.
Taiwan in the building. Going to be a great one in the co-main event as he defends his title. But coming up next, Revo Shore Sommai taking on Furkan Karabag.
Empty your mind. Be formless, shapeless, like water. If you put water into a cup, it becomes the cup. You put water into a bottle, it becomes the bottle. You put it in a teapot, it becomes the teapot. Water can flow, or it can crash. Be water, my friend.
This guy has 17 first round finishes. Do not blink.
Live crowd are about to see some knockout action.
Bravo Stavridis! It's a win for Greece!
The heaviest hands of any woman in one championship, Mongo.
See how she handles this great.
Jamal's out. She's gone. Mongo nailed her.
fighters in them. They're dangerous. They're destructive. A Y2K retention was huge for Wu. No, from out of nowhere. Wu just unleashed with that big right hand.
BJJ of Morello, Sambo of Bektasarian.
Yeah, I expected this. Immediately, Rodrigo drops down, starts working for those legs. Look at him. He's immediately got the leg.
Oh, it's over! Morello wins his first fight in ONE Championship.
Return. The best of the best have blessed this iconic stadium, and it continues to roll on tonight. Coming up in our featured fight of the night, Revo Sommai taking on Furkan Karabag in this catchweight Muay Thai contest. Global rules Muay Thai, 3 3-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. 3 knockdowns in a round, that equals a TKO. No throws or grappling in this one.
เราเป็นมวยหมัดตัวตายเดินอยู่แล้วครับเตะขาต่อยหมัดเดินบู้อยู่แล้วครับ
My strength will be box because small gloves is different game.
จุดแข็งของผมก็น่าจะเป็นหมัดซ้ายเตะซ้ายนะครับเพราะว่าแต่ก่อนเคยได้ฉายาซ้ายมาตัดหลังมาครับ
He looks tough and strong. I don't think he ever misses, but in the fight, everything is, can happen.
จุดอ่อนของคู่แข่งน่าจะเป็นเตะขาเราเน้นเตะขาไปครับ
We both try to go hard, and when we going hard, it's possible.
ต้องชนะน็อกแน่นอนครับ
From the blue corner, Furkan Karabag!
Furkan Karabag! Representing the WMC Lamai Muay Thai Gym out there in Koh Samui, this five-time Muay Thai and kickboxing Turkish champion is now here at ONE Championship, ready to make his debut on ONE Friday Fights, Iony.
Furkan Karabag, the Turkish fighter from WMC Lamai, his good friend and training partner. We saw a couple weeks ago, Erdem Dincer was able to pick up a huge win here. And Furkan Karabag is looking to follow with the results like that. Furkan has a very forward offensive style. Strong hands. He can hurt you with left and right. He's got beautiful body shots. You see him in his corner there with his coach, Jack Lamai. I'm so excited to watch this man compete because he can string up combinations so well. And in these small gloves, I think he can do the damage that will hurt Revo so much.
Yeah, in his six-week camp, he focused on adding power to his elbows. He wanted to go right at Revo. Immediately start throwing those bows. He knows how dangerous that Revo is, especially in that punching range. He wants to shut that down and start throwing those elbows. It's very important that he goes first. He needs to block the oncoming punches and look to counter with elbows. This is a really fun fight, and I'm looking forward to watching these two. Man, I was standing next to Furkan a couple hours ago. This dude is a giant, Johnny.
From the red corner, Revo Sommai!
Revo Sommai, the WBC Muay Thai World Champion. He's got a dangerous Muay Thai style. Likes to come forward, put those hand combinations together. Really has big power in that right hand, but he's also got power in the left as well, and that's where he does his best work. He will put you out if you give him a chance with that left hand.
Revo told us for this camp, he has worked on specifically the power in his punches and his elbows. He can go forward, and I think these two will really clash in the middle. Can Furkan land the punching and the kicking? Can he find the hold through guard of Revo? Or will Revo be able to land the punches and the elbows of his own?
Yeah, this is not Revo's first rodeo in small gloves. He likes the feeling of knuckles to the dome, and he plans to do a lot of it. He's very cerebral in his game plans, right, Gianni? He likes to break his opponents down and find their weaknesses, and he plans on doing that here tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of One Friday Fights 5. Three 3-minute rounds of a 154-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of WMC Lamai Muay Thai, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 25-6. Representing Turkey, Furkan Karabag! And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, he is a WBC Muay Thai World Champion, training out of Sommai, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 60-15. Representing Thailand, Revo!
Karabag seals off each one of the corners. You can see each athlete has the mongkong wrapped around their head and the Ploymuangjan armbands around their biceps. The Ploymuangjan armbands were originally given to soldiers before they went off to battle by the mother of the wife by tearing off a piece of the sarong. Head nod to Michael Cervello, as it was one of his favorite statements about the Ploymuangjan armbands, but you know, you just see the tradition and the beauty, Gianni, of this dance.
All right, guys, understand the rules, you're fine on the Muay Thai rules, okay? In the event of a knockdown, make sure you get neutral corner. Touch gloves, back to your corners. Judge, time. Go.
The very best strikers in the world come out of this historic Lumpinee Stadium.
You ready?
As these two try to work their way up the ladder and reach the upper echelon of the sport, as Revo immediately comes out with a high left roundhouse kick.
He just slams him with a big head kick by Revo. Revo is not playing games.
Revo is throwing heat off of both legs in that southpaw stance as Karabag goes a little bit low on his retaliation shot.
Okay, let's go.
Wow, what a start by Revo, though. Throwing heat, left kick, body, head, he is throwing everything with power. Furkan needs to close the space and not allow Revo to throw those kicks at that range. Hey, that's it. Great work by Furkan now to slip out the way of the kicks.
Karabag trying to close that distance, utilize those close range strikes, but he's got the reach advantage, but he's trying to close that distance.
Oh!
Revo throwing Karabag to the canvas. Yes, it's true, ladies and gentlemen. The West might have Madison Square Garden, but the East has Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. The very best strikers on the planet are in this iconic building. As Karabag tries to go high and immediately gets pushed back by Revo. Sommai.
Revo just dominating the range from the outside with the kicks. And right! Left hand there by Revo. He's just one step ahead right now, Mitch. With all the rage, but with these 4-ounce gloves, anything can happen. And Furkan there. Eats a
throws a right hand at Revo.
Good movement, counter striking as Revo's trying to bait in Karabag to land a big left hand, but Karabag has got no backing down as he continues to push forward. Nice high roundhouse kick attempt there, missed. Followed up with a nice jab. I like the way Karabag's putting shots together. But Rob Revo in that left hand is a serious weapon.
But Revo's got to watch out at the moment. Furkan's gaining confidence. He's stepping in. Revo cannot take so many shots to the chin because one of them will hurt him.
Revo's trying to counter with that right hook. He's touching Karabag as Karabag continues to push forward. But what a beautiful time. Cut kick to take out the legs of Karabag.
Revo showing the full display. Kicks, sweeps, elbows, clinching, everything on tonight. Look at Karabag. No, not stopping. Looks good there. Right hand by Furkan with the elbow to follow up. Oh!
Ooh, they both answer and trade lead hand hooks. Revo lands a big elbow at the dying seconds of the first round. But what a first round it was, Keanu.
What a first round. Revo saw Sommai started out strong and hard. Here's a spinning elbow attempt here. Straight left by Revo. Revo just showed so much in the first round. Sweeps, punches, knees, switch kick there, but Furkan Karabag was able to find some success towards the latter half. Punches that landed right on the chin of Revo saw Sommai. Close contest. That's the low blow there at the beginning of the round. Revo calling him on, but dang, right there. Cannot take too many of those, Mitch.
No, you can't. Trading big hooks.
Come on.
I'll test your chin, you test mine. Let's see who falls first.
Okay.
Revo, Sommai, Furkan, Karabag. Round two. Underway. Lots of feints coming from Karabag early as he continues to push forward. Saying Trudeau's word. Saying he wanted to put the pressure on Revo. Of course, Revo to counter strike as he evades the high kick and then comes back with a low kick.
Oh, nice work there. Fainted it and went up. Right hand down the guard. Good start here for the second round, but again, Revo just says, bring it on.
Furkan's attacking that lead leg. He's going inside leg kick, often and heavy here in the second.
Working off that paint pitch. Trying to draw the kicks out of Revo and land the punches that he wants. Oh, but just beautiful sweep again. Revo with the clear, just a master of that.
Revo baits nicely with the long guard. Defense in front of his face to avoid that big right hand that Karabag is throwing heavy and often. Again, Karabag lands a nice little inside leg kick and chooses to go up high. Showing that experience.
It makes you so tired having to get up off the ground like that repeatedly. And at the moment, Furkan Karabag with the forward pressure. Revo with the trickiness, getting out the way of the punches.
Karabag throwing heat with that right hand as Revo's forced to duck under and get out the way.
Big right hook there.
Really well for Furkan, man.
So well. He's drawing up the kick to counter, but at the moment, Revo wants to draw him into the elbows like we talked about. Swelling under the eye. Revo starting to show. These small gloves just do so much damage. Furkan on the front foot. Revo on the ropes. Even to slow down. Nice elbow there through the guard of Furkan. This is a high pace they put on by Furkan, Mitch.
Yeah, that forward pressure, man, just drains you. It just sucks the wind out of you to hit somebody with your best shots. But Revo, he'll still throw. He likes that counter hook.
But he seems
must be slowing down. He's not as explosive as he was in the first round. Deep, deep breath there by Revo. Nice jab by Furkan.
I like Furkan Karabag to go to the body. You can see the mouth starting to open on Revo Sommai. This is Furkan's opportunity to really capitalize in this second round.
Furkan, oh, nice leg kick that drops him.
Again with the inside leg kick.
Big, big ending to that round by Furkan. That pressure on relenting. Was able to keep coming at Revo. Revo still with a lot of tricks in there. Angles off, beautiful sweeps, but it is the pressure from Furkan Karabag that's starting to show. He's doing damage under the eye as well. And that's the leg kick that took the legs under Revo. Big leg kicks by Revo. Kicks to the body, kicks to the legs. Revo did some good work, but it was all Furkan Karabag, late second round.
It seemed like he had an answer for the left kick, right? He was able to deflect it and encounter, create the feints, create those openings, and really score some heavy shots in the latter part of that round as Revo looked to be fading slightly. This third round is really important. It could be tied
a piece. Go back, go back.
It could come down to the third and final round in this catchweight Muay Thai contest at the historic Lumpinee Stadium, where the best of the best from around the world compete, and two of them are in the ring right now. A lot of feints coming from that close range from Furkan Karabag.
Oh! Straight left! Rocked him! Revo Sommai on the attack!
Furkan was able to cover, defend, Sommai. Trees of Furkan Sommai. That's it. TKO with leg kicks.
Wow. Furkan fighting for so much more than himself. He told us that he had the earthquake in Turkey. He wanted to get on the mic, and he really put it forward, Mitch. In the third round, he found the will. He found the way. Got rocked, but came back with a leg kick knockout. Wow. Here you go. Gets rocked by Revo. Revo on the front foot. Just chasing down Furkan. He thought it was over. Bang! Leg kick. Drops him. What a victory here from Furkan, bitch.
How often do you see stoppages due to inside leg kick? Not outside. Inside. That's the power of Furkan. Furkan Karabag gets touched. Retreats back. Wobbles. Going backwards. But then goes inside to drop Revo Sommai.
What a victory for Furkan Karabag. Big, big victory. Was able to get rocked, come back, and pick up a third round KO victory. So rare to see a leg kick victory. But let's go to Mitch for the interview.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 37 seconds in the third round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Furkan Karabag!
Furkan Karabag, the man from Turkey, gets it done in the third round. Had to battle through some hard kicks, some sweeps from Revo Sommai, but wow, what a victory. Inside leg kick takes out the leg of Revo Sommai. Let's go to Mitch Chilson for the interview.
Furkan Karabag, third round TKO by inside leg kick. That was wild, bro. How are you feeling?
Actually, I'm feeling painful, you know, my country situation. I said before the fight, nothing like anymore cannot hurt me, you know. Just I know this day, this fight for my country, and I want to say them, please take this and maybe I can give it you a little bit smile. And if you have time, I want to say, I should say the thank you for one championship, Yodbuangarm Cherry, make this platform to make have our voices heard, you know. Thank you so much, everyone who support us and who support the Turkey And please don't forget, these things, earthquake, will take time, and please keep this spot and help us. And we will grateful to us, grateful to you, you know. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you so much.
Furkan, our hearts go out to everyone in Turkey and Syria. I know you were fighting for something much bigger than yourself, and that could be why you put on such a tremendous performance. But for that performance, how about 350,000 baht from Chatri Sinyatong, the CEO of ONE Championship?
Thank you so much. You helped me, then now I can help the people. Thank you so much.
Lumpinee Stadium, please give it up for your winner, Furkan Karabag!
Furkan Karabag picks up 350,000 baht. He wants to help out the victims of the tragedy there in Turkey and Syria. Big victory from the man. He picks up the Monster Energy fight of the night with that third round KO victory. Furkan Karabag takes out the leg of Revo Sommai. Had to battle hard to pick up this victory over a very tough, very talented Revo Sommai. But Furkan Karabag, with the pressure, the pace, and the passion behind him, gets rocked here in the third and final round, but was able to find the will, the desire to end this fight with the inside leg kick victory. Furkan Karabag picks up the Monster Energy fight of the night. What a performance by the man from Turkey.
Where there's a will, there is a way. And Furkan Karabag found a way. But there's plenty more action coming your way. Goodbye to our broadcasters all around the world. But please join us on YouTube, Facebook. We got a lot more action coming your way here from the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. Welcome back to ONE Friday Fights here at the legendary Lumpinee Stadium in Bangkok, Thailand. I'm Mitch Chilson, that's Gianni Suba, and what a night it has been so far, but we're just getting started. Check out the main event to headline this incredible night.
Kongklai Annymuaythai takes on Superball Tded99 in our main event of the evening. Kongklai is the 2020 Sports Authority Thai Fighter of the Year. En route to picking up that award, 10-fight knockout streak. He can knock you out with his left and his right. And in these 4-ounce gloves, he is such a dangerous man. But standing in his way is Superball Tded99, a man with pace, with clinch work and knees. Can Kongklai find a knockout like he has time and again? Or will the pace and the clinching of the knees of Superball Tded99 be the key to victory?
Big questions will be answered, but before we get to the main event, we've got a jam-packed card for you. Check out the Catchweight Muay Thai contest between Denkriangkrai taking on Songchana. That's gonna be fireworks. Really looking forward to the Strawweight Muay Thai contest as Teeyai PK Saenchai takes on Jelte Blommaert. Really looking forward to that. But to kick us off is a Catchweight Muay Thai contest. Yodbuangarm taking on Khunsuk. It won Friday fights. We've got global rules Muay Thai. That's 3 3-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. 3 knockdowns in a round equals a TKO. No throws or grappling in this one. Let's go.
From the blue corner, Khunsuk so Dechapan.
Khunsuk Dechapan. This man says his best weapon is his right hand. He's been coming in here on short notice, Iony, but this guy, it doesn't matter who's standing in front of him, he is going to walk them down and try to put hands on him. And if you put those hands inside little gloves for the first time, I'm looking forward to this guy.
The reason why he's so confident, bitch, is he has that style. Doesn't matter how many weeks, his game plan is to go forward and put pressure on his opponent with kicks and knees. He's best when he lets his hands, kicks, and knees flow, when he steps forward and dictates the fight. This is the first time in 4-ounce gloves, but he says he feels he has much more power in these gloves, so he's excited to step in there and throw.
Yeah, I asked him, I was like, dude, what's your key to victory? How do you win this? And he said, I'm gonna punch him more than he's gonna punch me. That was his answer. He plans to be stronger and faster. He knows that his opponent is a counter striker. So it's really important for him to go first and go fast. He wants to come out blazing. As soon as that bell rings, he knows just how good and well-rounded his opponent is. So he really wants to apply a lot of pressure and not allow Yodbuangarm to start getting off those combinations. This is gonna be a fun fight in Catchweight Muay Thai.
From the red corner, Yodbuangarm, Luckybuntherng!
Yodbuangarm is in the house. Lumpinee Stadium welcomes this highly respected, well-rounded striker. He only got a few weeks notice on this one, but he's coming off of a disappointment back in November of last year, and he said he went right back into camp and started working, but he got notice only 2 weeks, so he's really in good shape, and he plans on redeeming himself for a loss by decision. But in that loss, he learned to have a little bit more confidence in himself, a little more belief. When you enter inside the arena, you have to have that strong conviction, and that's what he has walking into this one. He believes he's got the reach, he's got the speed, and he wants to utilize the distance and then start throwing those kicks, Iony.
Yep, this will be a contrast of styles. Yodbuangarm at that point for more style. He likes his knee, he likes to stay on the back foot and read the fight. He tells us he wants to wait for Khunsuk to step in so he can slam his kicks in. Once he finds a range for the kicks, he will look to land the elbows as well. He wants to use that range, dictate the pace. He's not afraid to push it if he has to, bitch. Range will be in his favor. Power
will be in the favor of Khunsuk Saw Dechapan. This is a very, very fun matchup to kick off this latter half of the card, Mitch.
Yeah, we got a stylistic matchup between two brilliant strikers. We've got that forward pressure that comes from Khunsuk, and then we've got this long-range Muay Thai style that comes from Yodbuangarm. So, interesting stylistic matchup, and this is going to be fun.
Next up, we have three three-minute rounds of a 112-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Saw Dechapan, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 50 and 11. Representing Thailand, Khunsuk Saw Dechapan. And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Luckybuntherng, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 50 and 10. Representing Thailand, Yodbuangarm, Luckybuntherng.
Khunsuk Saw Dechapan in the black and gray shorts. Yodbuangarm Luckybuntherng in the gold and white. As Khunsuk lands a nice little two-punch combination.
Yeah, just like he said he would, he wants to walk forward. Yodbuangarm cannot let him walk into the punching range. He needs to keep him away with a little bit more teeps. We're going left kicks, right kicks to the body and arms. Hey, big kick.
Yodbuangarm has a bit of a reach advantage. He's got like 3 inches in height, but he's just not utilizing the jab and the push kicks. There's one push kick, but you can see Khunsuk is just trying to walk him down and put hands on Yodbuangarm. Nice check from Yodbuangarm as he looks to unload a right hand.
He throw back more of that teeth and the left kick just to deflect and distract Khunsuk just like that. Yeah, there you go. Nice forward kick there by Yodbuangarm. This is a very dangerous range. He's letting Khunsuk walk into that punching range. Like a very dangerous game.
Khunsuk's trying to go to the body. He's all around there, which is great. He's just trying to break down your opponent. And those kicks, they're landing. Reverberates around this jam-packed stadium here in Bangkok, Thailand, the iconic Lumpinee Stadium. Both these guys have been here before, and they love the feeling and the vibe that they get from competing at this legendary stadium. Good hand combinations landed by Khunsuk.
Uppercut there by Khunsuk, narrowly misses. Yodbuangarm does not want to get into exchange like this.
Oh! Khunsuk knocking the crotchet armbands off of Yodbuangarm.
And I'm loving his stance, just lats wide. Medicine walking down Yodbuangarm.
Yeah, just walking through punches. I like the counter elbow that Yodbuangarm was throwing there a couple of exchanges ago, but he seems to have abandoned the close range elbows. He's just letting Khunsuk go to work on that body.
That's the problem with these small gloves, Mitch. You cannot go to the high ground because there's so many openings. Khunsuk's fighting the right hand to the body. Barely missing with the uppercut, but that's better work by Yodbuangarm.
Yeah, Khunsuk just landing with a lot more authority, a lot more impact. As Khunsuk upends Yodbuangarm.
Controlling the ring so well as Khunsuk just walking down Yodbuangarm. Yodbuangarm at the moment, a couple left kicks out there, but he is struggling against the pressure and the power of Khunsuk.
Khunsuk's got some speed on that right kick. The only thing Yodbuangarm was able to do is catch it as Khunsuk lands a nice little four-punch combination to end the round as he pounds on his chest, announcing that he won that round.
I would have to agree with him. Some of the action here. beginning of the round, Yodbuangarm was able to land some good kicks. But it was the pressure, the power punching of Khunsuk. Just kept throwing at him, right hand to the body. Kicks to follow up. Khunsuk just stayed in Yodbuangarm's face. Yodbuangarm had some success with the kicks, but wasn't enough. Khunsuk with the big power punches there. First round for Khunsuk.
Khunsuk just has an answer for a lot of what Yodbuangarm's doing, whether it's a catch and a counter and then another kick, or the hand combinations, or walking him down with the hand combinations first to really put that pressure and just keep Yodbuangarm on his back foot. Let's see if he continues this same strategy of trying to walk down Yodbuangarm, and what kind of adjustments can Yodbuangarm make inside the corner? If you were in Yodbuangarm's corner, what would you tell him to be doing?
More teeth to the body, more left kicks to the arms of Khunsuk. He cannot let him walk into that punching range, because at the moment, he's letting him watch. That's better work. Gets into the rub, he needs to angle out or clinch. Tie him up and keep him away. Because at the moment, he's staying in that punching range. Khunsuk can go all night long.
Yodbuangarm's starting to egg on Khunsuk, which doesn't seem like a very good idea, especially when he starts letting go of those hand combinations. He kind of just freezes Yodbuangarm in the corner as he unloads multi-shot combinations.
Nice kick, that's better work, but again, he stays inside that range. Khunsuk unloading with combinations. Body, head, kicks, punches, everything. Khunsuk's letting him fly. Gets it done. Second round in the crowd here at Lumpinee Stadium. Loving it.
With the body shots crumbling. Yodbuangarm. Khunsuk scores Dechapan.
Yodbuangarm just did not do enough to keep Khunsuk away. He let Khunsuk operate in that punching range, and Khunsuk said, okay, I'll show you what I can do. Body, head, just did not stop coming with the combination. And he said, once he lets the combination go, that's when he's best. And exactly what we talked about, the holes in the guard here, in these small gloves, left uppercut does the job, right hand to the body finishes it. Khunsuk saw Dechapan, impressive performance here. Takes a second round KO. Bang, follows up. I'm on head nod, little raw tag there. Body, head kick follows up. Khunsuk just showing him that Muaythai style. Right, right, all night long. That's the one that hurts him. Yodbuangarm falls to the ground. Big victory for Khunsuk Saw Dechapan.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 52 seconds in the second round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of knockout, Khunsuk Saw Dechapan!
War to celebrate Khunsuk Saw Dechapan. Combination after combination was able to find the body, find that left uppercut that hurt Yodbuangarm. Got the job done. Let's go to Mitch for the interview.
Khunsuk Saw Dechapan, what a performance, second round KO. How you feeling?
วันนี้เป็นการต่อสู้ที่เยี่ยมยอดมากครับได้น็อกเอาท์ในยกที่2รู้สึกยังไงบ้างครับตอนนี
้รู้สึกดีใจครับผมก่อนชกก็ตื่นเต้นมากครับแต่พอขึ้นชกก็มีความมั่นใจมากครับก็วันนี้ก็ดีใจมากครับที่ชนะน็อกครับวันนี้
I'm very happy and excited, but once I'm on the ring, I'm very confident that I would get a knockout.
And a knockout is just what you got. You told us earlier this week that you wanted to come out here and go fast and go first, and that's exactly what you did. Did anything surprise you in here tonight?
ก่อนหน้านี้นะครับเรามีการทำการสัมภาษณ์ว่าพี่เนี่ยจะมารุกเร็วรุกแรงแต่ว่าศึกในคืนนี้เนี่ยมีอะไรที่ทำให้พี่เซอร์ไพรส์หรือเปล่าครับ
เซอร์ไพรส์ครับผมก็ตั้งใจมาดีครับไปนี้ครับว่าจะอัดเขาให้ได้ครับก็ทำได้ครับวันนี้ครับก็ขอบคุณบอสชาตรีมากครับที่ทำให้ผมได้ขึ้นมาชกเวทีแห่งนี้ครับผม
Right, nothing's really surprised me. I put my game on and I want to thank Big Boss Khun Chatri สุดยอดทง
Well, the big boss, Kru Chatri Sinyotong, wants to thank you too. How about 350,000 baht for that knockout win here tonight from the CEO of ONE Championship?
ครับได้เงินรางวัล 350,000 บาทจากคุณชาติสินยอดทองครับรู้สึกไงบ้างครับ
ก็รู้สึกดีใจครับผมที่ได้โบนัสครับก็ขอบคุณบอชาติมากครับผมขอบคุณครับ
I feel really happy and I want really to thank from deep of my heart to คุณชาติสินยอดทอง
Great fight can't wait to see you back ladies and gentlemen please give it up for your winner Khunsuk Sor Dechapan
Khunsuk Sor Dechapan gets himself a 350,000 baht bonus from the big man himself, Chatri Sinyotong. Big performance by Khunsuk. Don't go anywhere though, we have much more coming up. Ploymuangjan versus Iony Lawrence after the break.
Are about to enter the ring here in Bangkok, Thailand. Ploymuangjan from Sommai Muay Thai takes on Iony Lawrence in this catchweight Muay Thai contest. Global rules, three-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. Three knockdowns in a round, TKO. No throws or grappling in this one.
From the blue corner, Iony Lawrence!
Iony Iron Fist Lawrence. 19-3, Gianni. She comes out in a Fairtex gym. This 21-year-old British striker does not take a step, backward step, and plans. Putting on a show.
Iony Lawrence has been training at a very young age with her father. Now has moved to Fairtex gym in Pattaya. She tells us strong pressure, heavy style is her style. K1 aggression. She doesn't like to let her opponents get comfortable. That is what she attributes to her success, bitch. She's done a 4-week training camp hard here in which Mr. Wong himself pushed her to do the extra work.
She gave her daddy attention, and she said that meant so much to her, and it made her push herself so much more.
Yeah, when the owner of Fairtex is watching you train and then gives you that extra push at the end of every session, you know you are going to walk into your fight in your absolute best form possible. And that's what we're expecting from Miss Lawrence here today. She spent 6 weeks in Fairtex, really focusing on her boxing and putting long combinations together.
From the red corner, Ploymuangjan, Smile Muay Thai!
Ploymuangjan, Smile Muay Thai, enters this catchweight contest rocking a 54-15-1 record. You know, she owns Smile Muay Thai out there. She named it after her daughter. And she's got a lot of fighters out there, but this was her opportunity to really step up on that global stage here at Lumpinee Stadium and make a name for herself. Her last fight was a little while ago because she's been busy running that gym, Gianni, and training her fighters, but she's still sharp, she's still hungry, and ready to go.
Yup, she's been fighting since the age of 9. She has a very technical style, likes to read fights and then find the opening. Like you said, she took some time off to build Smile Muay Thai with her husband. And now she's motivated to showcase her skills, showcase her style to her students back at Smile Muay Thai. That was the primary motivation for her to come back. And she's got so much experience in the ring. That experience, she says, is the difference here. She had so much fight. She has faced so many fights with different styles. Iony is the pressure style, but Ploymuangjan thinks she has this recipe to work against that pressure heavy style.
Yeah, Ploymuangjan was talking to us about she's normally a heavy right kicker, but for this fight, she really wants to let go with her left more because her opponent is a forward fighter. So she doesn't want to be too aggressive soon. She wants to pick her shots and ready to get a knockout.
And now we have three 3-minute rounds of a 132-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest presented to you by Monster Energy. Unleash the beast. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Fairtex, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 19-3. Representing the United Kingdom, Iony Iron Fist Lauren. And introducing her opponent, out of the red corner, training at a small Muay Thai gym, representing Thailand, Ploymuangjan, Smile Muay Thai.
Okay, bit of a knockdown, must go neutral corner. Touch gloves, back to your corners, please. Judge, time. You ready?
Iony Lawrence in the multi-colored shorts, Ploymuangjan in the pink. As they immediately start to engage, there's that left kick Ploymuangjan was talking about. She's trying to counter that forward pressure of Iony Lawrence, as Iony Lawrence is staying true to her word and not giving Ploymuangjan a chance to breathe and catch a breath.
Yep, it's the hands, the power, the pressure of Iony. Ploymuangjan doing a good job, staying on the outside. Iony looks like she's got heavy, heavy hands, bitch.
Yeah, she's definitely letting Ploymuangjan know that she is there inside that pocket. Every single shot she's throwing, you can see the head whipping back of Ploymuangjan as Iony Lawrence is doing some work inside the clinch as she breaks a little separation just to drop some elbows.
Nice work inside the clinch. Ploymuangjan needs to throw some back here.
Jab is working well for Iony. As Ploymuangjan just seems to keep running into that jab.
That's better. Throw the kicks. Stick to the game plan. Don't get caught up in a punching war with Iony.
Definitely looks to be the stronger, more powerful of the two.
going to try to break Ploymuangjan with those hand combinations to work inside that clinch. Nice jab again from Michael Lawrence.
At the moment, Wendy just trying to trade with her. That's a very bad idea. Iony has the power advantage. She's got the boxing advantage in that jab that just landed for her. Ploymuangjan needs to find a way to stop the pressure.
Jab is kind of spinning her head to the side, too. It's a lot of movement as Ploy gets wilted by Iony Lawrence to get a stoppage in the very first round. Wow. Iony Lawrence did exactly what she said she wanted to do. Walk forward and put hands on the face of Ploymuangjan. Look at this, just getting overwhelmed.
Yeah, she put a lot of time into the boxing, she said, and it showed tonight. Just rattled off hand combinations and did not stop until the referee stepped in to save Ploymuangjan. Jab to the body, one, two, just continuous. Ploymuangjan didn't put up enough defense. The referee had to stop that one. Great, great performance here by Iony in her debut. Boxing combinations, did some good work inside the clinch as well with the elbows and the knees. Just pumping the head back of Ploymuangjan.
Let's get the official decision.
This match was presented to you by Monster Energy. Ladies and gentlemen, after 1:58 in the first round, your referee has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Iony
here. She worked so hard. A fantastic Pattaya there in her boxing and really showed tonight. She was so sharp, so fast, so quick. And did so much damage when she got there. Iony Lawrence, first round TKO. Don't go anywhere. We have next Teeyai PK Saenchai faces Jelte Blommaert after the break.
Comes into every match with one intention, go in there and destroy. Every technique thrown, timing and speed, USA's Janet Todd.
He is a box office blockbuster in every sense of the word, Rod Tang.
The most experienced striker on the planet. The reign of gold begins for Petlanov.
Look at the combinations landed by Lassiri.
Fairy tales come true. Lassiri just shocked the world.
This is when Superlek started to unload.
Superlek in his hometown takes home the belt.
Is Miller, the Hurricane Sundell, the youngest world champion in world history.
She is a world-class striker on every single level.
This is the moment for Saenchai. We have a new featherweight Muay Thai champion of the world.
He's feeling it right now.
Chingiz trying to finish him. That's all, folks.
Unbelievable. Wow.
It's another Italian kickboxing world champion, Jonathan DiBella.
Nung O continues to add to his unbelievable legacy.
Nung O, the house on fire. This is perfection. This is highlight reel. This is brilliant.
Lumpinee Stadium is not only the most prestigious stadium in Thailand, but arguably the greatest fight stadium in the world alongside the great Madison Square Garden, Gianni. And it's been a great night, but I'm really,
Looking forward to this one. Strawweight Muay Thai. Teeyai PK Saenchai takes on Jelte Blommaert in this Strawweight Global Rules Muay Thai contest. That's three 3-minute rounds. The 10-point must system will be used. Three knockdowns in a round, that equals a TKO. No throws or grappling. One Friday fight.
From the blue corner, Jelte Blommaert!
Jelte Blommaert comes from a small town in Belgium and has really put on some incredible performances, Iony, here in Thailand. And he's now making his way through the most iconic stadium in the world and is now ready for his opportunity. But he's been here before and he wants to get a shot back here again.
Jelte Blommaert from Belgium. He started with kickboxing, made his way to Muay Thai. When he moved here, Mitch, he went to FA Group solely to work on his clinching. This is a kid that knows what the holes are in his game, and he wants to plug them. Has added that clinch style to his one-month kickboxing game. I'm so excited to watch him compete. These small gloves. Small gloves spin in his favor because he likes to throw hands. He's tall for this division. He wants to stay away from the power side of Teeyai. He wants to disrupt the rhythm of Teeyai with kicks. And he wants to land his favorite spinning back kick to try and end the night.
Spinning back kick into the liver is how he's got it done before. Can he do it here tonight? He says he really wants to utilize the left kick and the teeps. He plans to be leg heavy in his attacks because he knows that Teeyai comes from that PK Saenchai gym, and that's a Muaythai style, so he likes this matchup, the contest in front of the title.
From the red corner, Teeyai PK Saenchai!
Striker. He likes to go fast and go hard. He's got about 55 wins in Gianni. 20 of them have been by nasty KO. This guy's got power in his hands. And then you put him into small gloves too? Woo! I'm looking forward to this guy.
See, one big thing he talked to us about was the atmosphere at PK Saenchai Gym. So many talented fighters. And that atmosphere makes the training fun for him. Because sometimes when the training's hard, it's hard for you to go back. But when it's fun, you have a good crew around you, you just grow so much more. That's why he's been able to find that success. He's now just focused on growing and learning. Like you said, he has that Muaythai style. He likes to go forward. That's how he earns his knockouts. Pressure, punches to the body, punches to the head, low kicks, high kicks. This is an incredible matchup between two young kids, Vince. I'm looking forward to this one.
Yeah, I asked T.I., I was like, what are your keys to victory? What are the things that you need to do in this matchup to be successful? And he just gave me one. He's like, all I need to do is go first. Not let Blommaert get a chance to start throwing his combinations and his weapons. Just continually push forward and look to shut him down at every opportunity. So going first is something to look for in this matchup as these two really match up well together. You've got, you know, that point for Burr, that kickboxing style of Jelte going up against that point Mott, that hand heavy, low kick style coming from Teeyai. So I like this matchup, and this is a big opportunity for both these guys to really make a name for themselves on the global stage here at Lumpinee Stadium. Teeyai goes over the top rope. And we're gonna get this strawweight Muay Thai contest underway.
Next, we have three 3-minute rounds of strawweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of FA Group, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 21-8. Representing Bell. Belgium, Jelte Blommaert. And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of PK Saenchai Muay Thai Gym, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 55 and 20. Representing Thailand, Teeyai PK Saenchai.
Jelte Blommaert in the red and black, Teeyai PK Saenchai in the black and gray, as these two strawweights start to throw hands at each other. Teeyai PK Saenchai, Gianni got the biggest pop we've heard in the second half of the card.
Crowd are loving it here in Lumpinee Stadium. Man, Teeyai showing you that one West style right off the bat. Low kicks, hooks and crosses. Jelte do something different here. I want to trade like that.
Jelte's doing a good job of circling to the weaker side. Teeyai trying to avoid that big right hand that Teeyai likes to throw, but Jelte's got to stay a little bit more aggressive and not let Teeyai go first. That's it. That was a nice hand combination. Narrowly missed with the body shot.
Teeyai so good at following up after that right kick. You go to that right kick to follow with the hard right hand. Look for that for this one.
Like how Teeyai went body shot to that leg kick. Found a home on each one of those shots.
That's a nice left kick by Jelte. Oh, that's the knees.
Ooh, coming right up the middle with a beautiful elbow is Teeyai PK Saenchai.
That was a good knee inside the clinch there. The clinch that he's been working on the FA group, Jelte.
Ooh, Jelte missing the spinning back kick, but go low with the leg kicks. I like that style. Look at Teeyai touching up the head, going to the body, going to the legs. Doing his really good work below the chin, Gianni.
Beautiful work there. Closing the distance so well as well. Using that footwork to close the gap like that with that 1-2. That was nice. Yeah, seems to have the power advantage in this one, Teeyai does. Big strong hands into the leg kicks. Jelte needs more of that. He needs to lift the tie up the clinch, possibly. Because at the moment, kickboxing range, all Teeyai.
Jelte said he wanted to create angles, but he kind of gets frozen when Teeyai starts to throw combinations. So he has to remember his game plan and keep moving.
Yeah, he doesn't want to trade.
Nice timing on that push kick, though, to catch him mid-spin. Teeyai smiles at Jelte, acknowledging the timing of Blommaert.
Well, we saw this high guard, right, with this little glove contact in our last bout, was able to find the hole. Jelte needs to be careful with the high guard here, because at the moment, Teeyai is getting real close with the hands.
Yeah, range is really important for Jelte when he gave us his game plan. You know, he said he wanted to stay far enough away so that he could kick Teeyai, but Teeyai couldn't punch him. But he kind of gets stuck in that punching range and is forced into exchanges like this.
Nice elbows inside the clinch. Cuts up Jelte. Teeyai, big round for the man from PK Saenchai. Let's look at some of the replays here, Jess. Bombs from Teeyai, left hook, right, elbows inside the clinch. That style is just so fun to watch. Point one, hands and elbows. This is the elbow here towards the end of the round. Jelte had some success with left kicks of his own, but he just stayed in that Muaythai range too much. He let Teeyai there rattle on combination after combination, but inside the clinch as well, Teeyai was just first to the elbow, first to the knee.
Yeah, let's see what kind of adjustments Jelte Blommaert can make in managing that distance and that range, because that was a really big point that he made very clear that he wanted to stay inside that kicking range. But when they are close, when they get tight, he needs to fire off those elbows as well, because he's allowing. It looks like Jelte might. Jelte is stuck on the stool. Is he going to answer the bell? I don't think Jelte got up off the stool. I think the
DK Saenchai.
It might have been the cut in that late first round pitch. Right at the end, that Teeyai was able to round all up an elbow on the inside and cut Jelte. The doctor's looking at it. I think the cut was too big. They have to call up the fight. Teeyai PK Saenchai picks up a first round knockout win.
Gianni, I think you're right. It was one of those beautiful timed elbows right at the end. Right from the clinch, snuck his way in. The cut had a slight delayed reaction. They went back into the corner. The cut man couldn't stop the flow of blood. I can see Dr. Jimmy right there telling the officials that it was a cut to the forehead. And TI, PK Saenchai, captures a big win by Dr. Stoppage. TKO.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 3 minutes in the first round, the doctor has called a stop to this contest. Your winner, by way of technical knockout, Teeyai PK Saenchai!
Teeyai PK Saenchai, able to find the elbow inside the clinch, cut up Jelte blue bar, and earn himself a first round victory. Impressive performance by the man from PK Saenchai, showcasing that white mud style. Combination leg kicks, punches, hands, legs. Let's go up to Mitch Joseph for the interview.
TI PK Saenchai, you walked out and immediately from the walkout to the fight, you put on a show. How do you feel about your performance here tonight?
พี่ตีใหญ่พี่เคแสนชัยตั้งแต่เดินออกมานี่สร้างประสบการณ์สร้างความมันให้กับคนดูตั้งแต่เริ่มเลยตอนนี้รู้สึกเป็นยังไงบ้างครับ
ก็อยากสร้างสีสันในรายการวันครับเพื่อจะได้มีกระแสตอบรับที่ดีต่อผมและต่อรายการด้วยครับครับผม
I want to put on a very fun entertainment for ONE Championship and for me, so there's a lot of traction to the ONE Championship here. It's a global event.
It was a lot of fun. I saw you having a lot of success with the hand combinations and the low kicks, but once you got inside that clinch, that elbow was all she wrote. Is that what you had in mind in your game plan?
ก็ตอนแรกนะครับพี่มีการใช้การเตะแล้วก็ใช้หมัดเข้าหาแต่พอเราใช้ศอกและดูว่าคู่ต่อสู้ในเริ่มเลือดไหลแล้วเนี่ยคิดว่านั้นเป็นการปิดเกมหรือยังครับก็ตอนแรกก็ไม่คิดว่าจะปิดเกมได้ครับแต่ว่าดูจากรอยบาดแผลเขาก็ลึกพอสมควรครับแต่ก็ไม่คิดว่าจะปิดเกมได้เร็วขนาดนี้ครับ
Originally, I thought I would not get that knockout so fast, but looking from his injury, it looks pretty deep, so it's become like that. So it's become a knockout.
Well, you definitely got that knockout very fast, but you know what you also got? How about 350,000 baht from the CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Sinyatong?
ก็ขอบคุณทุกคนมากครับที่คอยเป็นกำลังใจให้ผมคอยผลักดันผมในทุกๆด้านครับไม่ว่าการซ้อมการบำรุงแล้วก็การเป็นอยู่ครับผมขอบคุณมากๆครับวันนี้ผมทำได้แล้วครับขอบคุณครับ
I would like to thank all my supporters who've been with me along the way. I'm very happy and I'm speechless.
Lumpinee Stadium, show your love to your winner, T.I. P.K. Saenchai!
The crowd here at Lumpinee Boxing Stadium love it. Their boy T.I. P.K. Saenchai picking up that 350,000 baht bonus. With that first round knockout of a Jelte Blommaert, was able to sneak in the elbow and cut Jelte Blommaert for a first round victory. Coming up next, we have Ploypanlan versus Namphongnoi Sommai.
This guy has 17 first round finishes. Do not blink.
Two punches. Live crowd are about to see some knockout action. Stavridis! It's a win for Greece!
The heaviest hands of any woman in one championship, Mongbo.
See how she handles this weight.
There's the right hand! Jamal's out, she's gone. Mongbo nailed her, absolutely flattened her.
Some powerful punches in there, they're dangerous, they're destructive.
A Y2K retention was huge for Mu.
Moves from out of nowhere. Wu just unleashed with that big right hand.
BJJ of Morello, Sambo of Bektasarian.
Yeah, I expected this. Immediately, Rodrigo drops down, starts working for those legs. Look at him, he's immediately got the leg.
It's over! Morello wins his first fight in one championship.
Welcome back to Lumpinee Stadium, the Madison Square Garden of the East. What a night it has been, Iony. Lots of finishes. Have we had a decision yet? I don't think we have. I think everybody's been stopped. Coming up next is Flyweight Muay Thai. Ploypanlan taking on Namphongnoi in this Global Rules Muay Thai contest. Three-minute round. The 10-point must system will be used. Three knockdowns in a round, that equals a TKO. No throws or grappling in this one. Let's go. This one's going to be fun.
From the blue corner, Namphongnoi Sommai.
This guy trains at Teeyai. He's a right-handed counter striker with big KO power, Gianni. He's a technical fighter who likes to counter. He can be aggressive and go forward, but he prefers to draw people in and then make them pay for trying to get close.
As we saw in that PK Saenchai matchup earlier from Teeyai, Namphongnoi needs to be on the back foot. He doesn't want to trade with that PK Saenchai Boyman style. He wants to be on the outside, play that counter game. But he tells us if he has to, he has no fuss in getting there and trading. That's going to be plan B, though. Plan A, stay on the outside, look to bang the kicks to the head and the arm of the PK Saenchai athlete to disrupt that punching power, Mitch.
Yeah, he's in his three-week camp. He focused on his hands and his elbows, especially the defense, because he knows that his opponent is a deadly puncher with some nasty power. He plans to exchange and trade shots with the PK Saenchai product. He wants to test that strength, and I was baffled to hear that, bro, but he really believes in his chin, and he believes he can fatigue Ploypanlan in the later rounds, and that's when he's gonna be able to find the finish.
Three-minute rounds. Big challenge ahead of the man, Namphongnoi.
From the red corner, Ploypanlan, PK Saenchai.
Ploypanlan. Saenchai with 136 wins. Billion Gems is walking to the iconic Lumpinee Stadium ring. Ploypanlan is a forward pressure fighter. He trains to be aggressive. He likes to use that big right hand. And he says, in my one debut, he wants everyone to know who Ploypanlan is when this fight is done.
and I think they will. He's got that aggressive style that the PK Saenchai gym is known for. For this camp, Ploypanlan has been working on the punches and the elbows. He knows that Namphongnoi has a favorite disease, so that's when Ploypanlan is gonna look for the opening to land the big power in his hands and his elbows. He wants to be aggressive, and he wants to push the face hard up Namphongnoi.
Yeah, he says he's gonna be aggressive from the opening bell. Ding, ding, go, go. He says that bonus inspires him to train even harder and to push much, much harder than he normally would in a normal session because he wants that taste of that bonus from the CEO, Chantri Singyatong. He knows that his opponent is a Muay Thai, right? Likes to throw those knees, likes to throw those kicks. So he plans on just melting that distance and going right through him and applying a lot of pressure. This is going to be a fun fight. Both these guys are in tip-top shape and ready to make their mark at one Friday fight.
And now we have 3 3-minute rounds of Flyweight Muay Thai. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Sommai, representing Thailand, Namphongnoi Sommai. And introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of PK Saenchai Muay Thai Gym, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 136 and 44, representing Thailand, Ploypanlan PK Saenchai.
Okay, boys, on center, who's flying under? Muay Thai, yes. Men of a knockdown, managed to get neutral corner. Touch gloves, touch gloves, touch. You got better corners. Judge.
Namphongnoi Sommai in the blue.
Okay, you ready?
Ploypanlan, PK Saenchai in the black. Namphongnoi looks big out there, Gianni. Looks like he's got a height advantage. Ploypanlan, let's see if he can utilize it. Already snapping the head back. Ploypanlan.
Namphongnoi, like you said, using that range so well. Jabbing through, finding the hole in the guard. Ploypanlan.
Ploypanlan starting to work with the kicks.
He's gonna need to use that range because Ploypanlan has some big hooks on him.
Beautiful knee landed at the end of that exchange as they broke trade.
Temple and drops him.
Ploypanlan, that's a wrap. Namphongnoi. What a shot to put the lights out on Ploypanlan. Namphongnoi with a big first round KO.
He said that was plan B, but it came out right to plan B. Right hand here over the temple. Drops. Ploypanlan PK Saenchai.
What? Look at that. Beautiful timing. Walk down Ploypanlan and puts the lights out with one swift right hand. Namphongnoi Sommai with a first round KO finish, Gianni.
Snap the picture. Frame it up, this picture perfect right hand. End the night. First round knockout for Namphongnoi Sommai.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 57 seconds in the first round, your referee has got a stop to this contest. Your winner by way of knockout, Namphongnoi Sommai.
Namphongnoi Sommai gets the knockout victory in the first round of a Ploypanlan PK Saenchai. They used that height so well. They were able to find that jab early. And then came with that right hand right on the side of the temple that just drops Ploypanlan. Let's go up the bench for the interviews.
Namphongnoi Sommai. First round KO, under 60 seconds. How do you feel about your performance here tonight?
Namphongnoi ได้ knock out ต่ำกว่า60วินาทีตอนนี้รู้สึกเป็นยังไงบ้างครับ
รู้สึกลดความกดดันครับก็สมกับที่ฝึกซ้อมมาหนักที่สุดเลยครับแล้วก็วันนี้ก็ขอบคุณทุกพี่สมหมายแล้วก็บอสชาตีแล้วก็ขายไม่ได้ก็เฮียตีครับที่ช่วยซัพพอร์ตทุกอย่างครับ
Yeah, so it's like a relief for me. It's worth it. It's like all the time that I've been training is for this fight, this time here. And I want to thank to all my support. I want to thank Khun Chatri. I want to thank Hirti. They're always supporting me.
Yeah, you talk a lot about the work you put into this training camp, but you told us that plan A was to stay on the outside and utilize your kick, and plan B was to come forward and throw those hands. It seems like it was plan B right from the go.
ก็ตอนแรกที่เราคุยกันนะครับเหมือนกับแผนแรกเนี่ยพี่จะเตะอยู่ห่างๆแผน2เนี่ยเราถึงจะเข้าชกแต่ตอนนี้เนี่ยเหมือนจะใช้แต่แผน2อย่างเดียวเลยตอนนี้เป็นยังไงครับทำไมถึงเปลี่ยน
ก็ขอมาแรกก็เราก็ต้องแรกครับเพราะว่าผมก็ต้องพัฒนาไปข้างหน้าครับ
Because it come towards me so I have to fight him back
Yeah were you surprised by anything in here tonight were you surprised at how quickly you were to get the KO
วันนี้มีอะไรที่ทำให้เซอร์ไพรส์หรือเปล่าครับว่าเซอร์ไพรส์ว่าวันนี้ได้น็อกเอาท์เร็วขนาดนี้ที่เซอร์ไพรส์ป่ะครับที่ได้น็อกเอาท์เร็วขนาดนี
้ก็ดีใจครับก็ไม่คิดว่าจะเร็วขนาดนี้ครับก็ตั้งใจครับก็ตั้งใจทุกอย่างนะครับทุกอย่างที่ออกไป
Yes I do my best nothing really surprises me but I just try my best
Your best was very good it was so good in fact that the CEO of ONE Championship Mr. Chatri Sinyatong has given you a 350,000 baht bonus for that performance here tonight
คุณชาติมอบเงิน 350,000 บาทครับ
ก็ขอบคุณบอสชาติครับแล้วก็ลูกพี่สอนสมัยแล้วก็เฮียตีมากครับที่ให้โอกาสผมในครั้งนี้ครับ
I would like to thank Big Boss Khun Chatri. I want to thank my gym. I want to thank to all my supporters.
How does this change your life? What are you going to do with that bonus money?
จะเอาเงินไปใช้ทำอะไรครับ
มอบให้พ่อกับแม่ครับ ทั้งหมดเลยครับ
I will give all of it to my parents.
That is incredible. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for your winner. Make some noise. Lumpinee Stadium.
350,000 baht bonus for Namphongnoi Sommai. It has been raining down bonuses here at Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. Don't go anywhere. We still have Denkriangkrai versus Songchana and the main event Superball Tded99 versus Kongklai Annymuaythai after the break.
Submission the likes of which we've never seen before.
Right into the underneath, here's a heel hook.
Yep, and that was the submission!
That's a tap.
Sweet revenge for Alex Silva!
He goes Ashi Garami to the heel hook.
Protection!
That's quick, that's quick! Oh, look at him. Mustafa falling into a triangle. Triangle finish over his BJJ black belt.
Garuda versus B-Dash for the middleweight championship of the world.
Garuda throws it up, right? Let's see. This is tight.
Oh, it is tight.
That's tight.
That's tight.
Vitaly's going to sleep.
Oh, he's out. He's out. He's out. 16-0. And he puts B-Dash to sleep.Bantamweight Championship of the World!
Oh, big shot! Lineker's in trouble against the fence!
His cup
has been shattered.
This fight has been declared a no contest.
With a score to settle, Bricio Andrade and John Lineker.
What a night it has been, Gianni, here at the historic Lumpinee Stadium. The action has been nonstop, man.
It's been insane. Knockout after knockout, bonus after bonus. It's raining down bonuses all night, and it's not even done yet, Mitch. We got two more fights, and the main event as well coming up. It's absolutely insane here. The crowd has been loving the action.
Yes, they have, and this is the kind of striking you would expect at Lumpinee Stadium. The best of the best compete here, and we've got two more matches coming your way. But up next, we've got Catchweight Muay Thai. Denkriangkrai, Singha, Mawynn taking on Songchana, Brucelee in Global Rules Muay Thai. That's 3 3-minute rounds. The 10-point must system is in effect. 3 knockdowns in a round, that equals a TKO. No throws or grappling.
From the blue corner, Songchana, Brucelee!
Songchana, Brucelee. This guy is a giant for this weight, Gianni. He's got a beautiful long-range Singhanoi style, because that's the gym where he comes from. John Wei Parr is going to know a little something about that. He likes to throw those heavy knees, get inside the clinch, and make things dirty. He likes to go fast, but he needs to start quick, and that's going to be very important for Songchana as he pushes forward and looks to jump as soon as that bell rings.
Bitch, I love that nickname, Tall Brucelee. It's just paying homage to the fighter Tall Brucelee, the first guy that brought him to Santander. He now has adopted that name as he keeps training at Santander gym. But like you said, speed. And the first person to land is gonna find the victory here tonight. Songchana has been working on that right kick, the elbows, and the emphasis on punching because of these 4-ounce gloves. Very tough for his weight class, but he likes to start fast. It's gonna be a fun matchup, this one, Mitch.
Yeah, he says that his opponent has a dangerous left hand, but he can use his right hand, so it kind of evens the playing field. He believes speed is gonna be his key to victory here tonight, and he's excited about this opportunity because he has such a reach advantage.
From the red corner, Denkriangkrai, Singha,
Mawynn, an imposing figure at 130 pounds. This southpaw has a big left hand and a bigger left kick. He's riding a 2-fight win streak and plans to make it 3 in a row here tonight. And he plans on not just making it 3 in a row, but outclassing his opponent in the process. Really wants to pick him apart and put on the performance of his life.
He's really looking to intimidate Songchana with his music as well. He's got that style, white cow, pressure heavy, but he has to get past the range. He has to close that distance because on the outside, Songchana just has that reach with his teeth and his jabs. Can Denkriangkrai close that distance? Can Denkriangkrai get into the range and land the shots that he needs to land? That's the question that we'll have in this bout.
Yeah, this is a really fun fight. I like the stylistic matchup. You know, this is interesting because how does Denkriangkrai get over the reach advantage? How close is he gonna have to get? He's really gonna have to make things tight. He's gonna have to put those hands to work. And this is the first time that Denkriangkrai's been in small gloves, so that's a big factor as well. How does he handle this newfound power that he's got inside his hands? He's been working on his hands, his boxing, and his elbow. He predicts a first round KO via left side.
different guy. Sing Mawynn goes over the top in this catchweight Muay Thai contest.
Next up, we have 3 3-minute rounds of a 130-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Tha Sang Thien Noi, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 49-20. Representing Thailand, Songchana, Tha Brucelee. Introducing his opponent, out of the red corner, training out of Singha Mawynn, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 50-29. Representing Thailand, Denkriangkrai, Singha Mawynn.
Songchana tore Brucelee in the blue. Denkriangkrai, Singha Mawynn in the black and green. And this catchweight Muay Thai contest is underway. Denkriangkrai immediately going to work with that left low kick in that left hand. He says he would get Songchana out of there in the first with that left side.
Songchana needs to be careful, can't get overzealous. Because that power of Denkriangkrai is apparent. So stay on the outside, take his time, work with these kicks. This is much better work here from Songchana. Oh! The crowd just loving the action here at Lumpinee Stadium.
These two are coming out swinging and banging. Look at Denkriangkrai going to the work with the body. Songchana, nice little skip step there as he goes inside with a leg kick. Songchana's a tricky little fighter with that left, that right kick of his.
And throwing the elbow right off that kick as well. Very, very tricky work from Songchana. But Denkriangkrai though has a box behind him. Elbows over the top.
Songchana, a little low. The warning from the ref.
That's the danger of having those mirrored stances. One guy orthodox, one guy southpaw. You throw that inside leg kick, and it's really easy to come up a little too high. Especially when you have that kind of height difference. You know, you're kicking down at your opponent's legs. Easy to catch the inside of that cup.
And Denkriangkrai just gonna take his time here to catch his breath. Songchana with an unintentional shot. Nothing too serious. They're going to get right back into it.
Denkriangkrai, Singha Mawynn comes right to the center to meet Songchana Tor Brucelee. Closes that distance, gets inside the clinch. left kick. Kicks the arms of Songchana.
Nice work in the clinch by Songchana. What a first round here. The crowd absolutely loving it. Very back and forth, Mitch. Songchana thought Bruce Lee with the kicks and the pressure. But Denkriangkrai had some moments of his own. They have been training all first round. Inside the clinch, Songchana with some success with the knees, but Denkriangkrai has been rounding off some nice elbows on the inside.
Yeah, really utilizing that height well, right? He's at a disadvantage, but he's coming right up the middle. High roundhouse kick traded by both guys, but Denkriangkrai just a little bit more accurate, able to come under the arm as he goes up top there. See, just narrowly missing with the elbows, but Denkriangkrai is just a bit more accurate with those shots. Second round, but the latter half of the round, Songchana just can't wrestling guy the opportunity to breathe as they trade knees inside the clinch.
Mitch, I'm loving that the crowd sees the action. They understand the skill and technique involved by these two fighters, and they're applauding it. Highest level of Muay Thai here on display at the Lumpinee Boxing Stadium.
Well, this stadium has seen some of the most classic Muay Thai fights, so this audience is very well educated in the art of eight limbs. Nice right hand landed by Songchana as he continues to push forward. The Denkriangkrai is not backing down. Smart move to tie him up right there and just eat a couple of seconds off the clock. If Denkriangkrai is ahead right now, that's a very important move just to eat those valuable seconds off. We still got two more minutes in the third and final round of this catchweight Muay Thai contest.
Songchana, they're working so hard there inside the clinch. Every time he ties up, rattles the knee. Denkriangkrai hasn't landed a lot of elbows yet in this round. Beautiful, catches the leg, redirects it, and counters. Left straight off the face.
Nice left hand landed by Denkriangkrai. Denkriangkrai, Singha, Mawynn, not backing down, but Songchana toward Brucelee continues to push forward.
Big shots for that tie-up. This one is so incredibly close. As we head towards the final minute here in the third round, Songchana with the knees in the clinch.
Songchana toward Brucelee doing good work inside that clinch. Will it be enough as we approach the final minute?
Right hand by Songchana.
Catches the leg, fires off shot, switches hand, and continues to dunk. Beautiful work.
It's been so even, shot for shot, elbow for elbow with this one. Denkriangkrai right hand to the body. Songchana jab up top. What a fight this has been. Third round, 30 seconds left. Who will it go to? Songchana presses forward. Right kick, right hand.
Cards. Judge number one calls this contest in favor of Denkriangkrai. Judge number two calls this contest in favor of Songchana. And judge number three calls this contest in favor of your winner by split decision, Denkriangkrai Singha.
Gets the split decision victory after a back and forth battle. against Songchana or Brucelee. He did some good work there. In the inside with the upper elbow. Some great work with the sweeps. Punches on the inside. Listen to this crowd here at Lumpinee Boxing Stadium. Loving the action. Let's go to Mitch for the interview.
Denkriangkrai sore. Seeing Mawynn, what a fight. How confident were you when it went to the judges' scorecards?
I'm
100% confident because my weapons have more accuracy.
Yeah, that's one thing me and Gianni were talking about, is how accurate you were. What do you think was the biggest factor in you winning this match here tonight?
ก็วันนี้นะครับเราก็มองเห็นว่าพี่นี่มีอาวุธที่แม่นยำจริงๆแต่อะไรคิดว่าเป็นเหตุผลหลักที่ทำให้ชนะในวันนี้ครับผมว่าผมตั้งใจมากครับซ้อมมาเดือนกว่าเพื่อรายการนี้ผมซ้อมตั้งใจมากครับไฟนี้ก็เป็นนั้นว่าชนะผมก็ภูมิใจที่สุดแล้ว
I think because I've trained very, very hard for this fight.
We talked a lot about your training during this fight. What aspects, I can see your coach right here, Namphongnoi, in your corner. What aspects of your training were so difficult for you that you were able to bring into the ring with you? I trained everything. My fist, my elbow, my kick. I trained everything. And I trained really, really hard.
Yes, you did. And we can't wait to see you back in here again.
Lumpinee Stadium, please make some noise for your winner, Denkriangkrai Singha Mawynn.
Picking up the split decision here after a back and forth battle. He was just that much more accurate on the inside. Volume heavy, was able to stay in the fight the whole night, was not deterred by the range and the reach of Songchana. Big win for him. Don't go anywhere though. We have next our main event of the evening. Kongklai Annymuaythai takes on Superball Tded99 after the break.
What a night it has been here at the iconic Lumpinee Stadium. The very best in the world have competed in this stadium, and two of them are coming up next. Catchweight Muay Thai of 138 pounds. Kongklai Annymuaythai taking on Superball Tded99. Global rules of Muay Thai in this one, ladies and gentlemen. Three-minute rounds. 10-point must system will be used. Three knockdowns in a round, TKO. No throws or grappling in your main event.
เตรียมสู้ทุกลูกครับไม่ว่าจะเป็นเข่าหมัดศอกเตะ
จุดแข็งผมคือว่าอึดทนครับโดนอาวุธก็ไม่มีอาการยุบไม่เห็นครับ
จุดแข็งของผมเป็นมวยเข่าเป็นมวยไฟเตอร์ผมก็จะเอาเข่านี่แหละครับกระชากคู่ต่อสู้ให้ได้เขาเป็นมวยไม่ชอบเข่าครับนี่คือจุดอ่อนของเขาครับ
เขาเป็นมวยเข่าเราเป็นมวยหมัดถ้าเขาเดินออกมาไม่ระวังตัวก็อาจจะโดนหมัดเราได้เหมือนกันนะ
ในนัดนี้นะครับคู่ต่อสู้ต้องกลัวเข่าผมครับเพราะว่าผมเป็นมวยเข่าที่แทงเจ็บมากครับ
ถ้าจะน็อกได้ก็ประมาณยก1ยก2ครับ
ไฟนี้ผมหวังว่าจะน็อกได้ครับก็มั่นใจของผมครับ
From the blue corner, Superball Tded99.
Superball Tded99. This is a well-rounded southpaw striker coming off of back-to-back.In those knees, and he says that that's going to be his ticket into the winner's circle as he starts firing off those knees. He knows that Kongklai is going to come out firing, so he wants to shut him down, reduce that space, and start looking for those knees.
Superball Tded99 is a technician inside the clinch. He's so strong once he gets inside the clinch, and those kneesThat we talked about, that's the secret here, the key to victory against Kongklai. Well, Superball has the power as well to hurt his opponent. He knows that Kongklai is going to come forward. Superball has to tie up or look to pierce the knee as Kongklai steps forward. This is a huge, huge opportunity for Superball. Can he tie him up? Can he pierce the knee into Kongklai and pick up a massive victory here in the main event?
Yeah, Gianni, this is the first time he's competed in an organization like this. He wants to make the most of this opportunity. It's also the first time that Superball is in small gloves, so he's interested to see what it feels like to get hit with him, but more importantly, what it feels like to hit somebody in these small gloves. It's an entirely different game, especially when it comes to the defense, but his opponent is hand-heavy and ready for this opportunity.
From the red corner, Kongklai Annymuaythai!
Knockout, Kongklai Annymuaythai is in the building. This is the only man to KO Seksan with big gloves.Not to mention he's in little gloves right now. This guy is a power puncher of the highest order. He's a Muaymat stylist, and his punches slice through the guard like a hot knife through butter. You stick that in small gloves, Yanni? I know you're high on this guy. I know you like him a lot. Why don't you rattle off for the people at home what this guy's done?
Kongklai Annymuaythai. This kid doesn't just knock you out, man. He puts you to sleep. Power in both his hands. He can find the knockout with the elbows.He's just nasty. His style, no doubts about it. He's just gonna come out and try to end the night early. This is a big opportunity for him as well, Kongklai. And he wants to find the hole in the guard. He wants to find the chink in the armor of Superball Tded99. He has found
the knockout shot time and again. He's found he can do it late in the round. He has come back from lopsided decisions to come back in the very last round, fourth or fifth round, to land that knockout power. So don't count him out, Mitch. This guy can get it done.
The former 140-pound Omnoi Stadium champion back in 2020, he won the Sports Authority of Thailand Fighter of the Year Award, and to do that, he rattled off 10 KO victories in a row. This dude goes on streets where he puts people out. He likes to drain them, suck their soul, and then, once they're ready to go, he puts it on them.
In the main event, we have three-minute rounds of a 138-pound catchweight Muay Thai contest. Introducing first, out of the blue corner, training out of Tded, Cao Cao, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 70-19. Representing Thailand, Superball Tded99. Opponent out of the red corner, training out of Annymuaythai, holding a Muay Thai and kickboxing record of 75-15. Representing Thailand, Kongklai Annymuaythai.
Mawynn, both athletes begin by sealing the ring, saying a prayer in each one of the corners. Johnny, this is just one of the most impressive and expressive parts of Muay Thai.
These movements have been passed down by the teachers. Generations of history and tradition preserved here with these movements. And in a setting none more iconic than this legendary Lumpinee Stadium. They go through these movements, preparing their minds and their body for the battle ahead. Here praying, giving thanks to their parents, to the teaching of their teachers, and to God. It's such a beautiful display, Mitch. And I'm so happy I get to witness it here. Some of the best seats in the house.
This is a big time catchweight contest. Superball. Tded99, Cao Cao, the coach or the crew will remove the Mongkol as the Warriors prepare for the main event of one Friday night fight five. Nice little catch to the sweep.
Nice kick there.
Kongklai is marching forward, looking to put that right hand to good use as Superball immediately answers back.
Like that though, but Superball put Kongklai in the back foot, but he needs to not exchange there, because Kongklai, as we know, has the power to shut their lights off.
That right hook is landing on Superball. Superball needs to start firing off those knees like he said he was going to, especially inside that close range, Gianni.
Kongklai, the power in his right and his left, that left hook. The left hook he likes so much, but jab there by Superball pushes him back. Hopping leg kick there by Superball.
Kongklai trying to answer, but a nice check from Superball as he marches forward inside that clinch to throw those knees.
Those are sharp, sharp knees there by Superball. Those will drain the air of Kongklai. And as we know, the only knock on Kongklai can be conditioning in the later rounds. These knees by Tded99 will soften that, quicken that process. Big knee again by Superball. To the body of Kongklai.
Superball seems to be stronger in the clinch early on in this first round. Let's see if Kongklai can start put those hands to use. He's got big power in that right hand. He's starting to load up on that left. Narrowly missing. The Superball goes up top and rattles Kongklai with a head kick.
Round. Let's see if he can maintain this pace and that speed advantage here in the second.
He will find that opening to hurt you.
Muaythai comes back with a right hook of his own. That's that head kick there.
Yeah, that kick might not have been just pure momentum. That was a beautifully timed high kick that really took a lot of power and just saw Kongklai crash to the ground, but he was able to pop back up, but he came right back with a knockout as we go into the third and final round of our main event at the epic Lumpinee Stadium. That's the kind of strike you'd expect to see, Gianni. Good work inside by Superball. That's where he's done his best work tonight, is inside that clinch.
But Mitch, Kongklai was able to get past that guard of Superball, and again, Kongklai sneaks another in.
These are the rounds that Kongklai is the most dangerous. He starts to get you tired, he starts to find that accuracy in those shots. Look at Superball trying to shut down that punching power of Kongklai.
Kongklai is not allowing Superball to hang on him. He's working, pummeling on the inside. Ooh,
uppercut. Man, how do you score that second round?
Tough to score, but the pressure, I believe, after the knockdown from Kongklai, would give it a slight edge to Kongklai as we move to this final round.
Good work inside the clinch again, but look at Kongklai able to create space, find a little bit of room to land some punches. Yes, Superball does not want any space between him. He wants to shut down, close the distance, work inside the clinch.
In favor of your winner by unanimous decision. decision. Superball Tded99.
Superball Tded99 picks up the decision victory. It was so close. He was able to shut down the power of Kongklai, land the knees, kept the action going, was able to score all night long, had that head kick in the second round, and just kept the pace on Kongklai Annymuaythai. Such a close fight. Big, big victory for the men from Tded99. Let's go to Vince Shilton for the post-fight interview.
Superball Tded99, what a war. How confident were you when they were reading the judges' scorecards?
วันนี้สุดยอดมากเลยนะครับผมมั่นใจขนาดไหนครับกับการตัดสินของกรรมการครับ
ก็ขอบคุณมากครับก็ผมมั่นใจครับว่าผมก็ตั้งใจซ้อมมาอย่างดีนะครับก็แก้เกมเข้ามาครับก็แล้วก็พลาดไปโดนหมัดเขานะครับยกที่2แต่ก็เราก็กลับมาได้ครับ
I've been practicing really hard for this fight. I'm super confident, even though I made some mistakes, but I put my game back right where I want it.
Well, you made very few mistakes, but how surprised were you when he came back with that big knockdown in the second round?
แล้วรู้สึกเป็นยังไงบ้างครับตอนที่เขาทำพี่ล้มในรอบที่สองครับผมในยกที่สองครับ
ก็รู้สึกใจแป้วเหมือนกันครับแต่ก็เรายังฮึดสู้ขึ้นมาได้ครับเพราะว่าเราก็มั่นใจร่างกายของเราว่าเราซ้อมมาดีครับ
I got a little bit nervous, but I got my spirit back and I give it my all.
Yeah, we could see that your plan was to shut down his massive punching power with the clinch. Was that the game plan going into this fight?
ดูเหมือนว่าเกมของพี่เนี่ยก็คือการบลุกเข้าไปใกล้ๆแล้วก็การปล่อยหมัดแรงๆอันนี้เป็นแผนหรือเปล่าครับ
ก็ใช่ครับเป็นแผนด้วยครับเราก็ต้องเขาเป็นมวยหมัดอยู่แล้วครับบางทีเราก็ต้องไม่ใช่ว่าจะเอาแค่เข่าอย่างเดียวครับเราต้องมีสู้ทุกรูปแบบครับ
Yes, that is my plan for tonight. He is very good with his fists. I cannot just keep using my knee, so I have to adapt and use all my weapons.
I know your knee was your biggest weapon, but the clinch was a beautiful game plan, and it was so good that not only did you get the victory, but you got yourself a 350,000 baht bonus from the CEO of ONE Championship, Mr. Chatri Siddhartong.
คุณชาตรีสิทธิ์ยอดทองมอบเงินรางวัล 350,000 บาทครับ
ก็ขอบคุณคุณชาตรีด้วยครับวันนี้ผมก็ขอบคุณผู้หลักผู้ใหญ่ครับไม่ว่าจะเป็นเฮียตีที่Tded99แล้วก็เฮียสมหมายครับเฮียสมหมายสกุลแม่ตาด้วยครับที่ให้โอกาสแล้วก็คุณชาตีด้วยครับสุดยอดทงครับผมขอบคุณมากครับแล้วก็แฟนหมัดมวยทุกคนเลยครับผมขอบคุณมากครับ
I would like to thank my gym, all my supporter, and คุณชาตีสุดยอดทง for giving me the opportunity to be here.
Great fight, Superball. Can't wait to see you back inside this ring.Kongklai Annymuaythai, what a great fight. How confident were you when they were reading the judges' scorecards?
วันนี้มีความมั่นใจขนาดไหนครับผมกับการที่รอกรรมการตัดสินครับ
ก็มีความมั่นใจเต็มร้อยครับเพราะว่าเราต่างคนต่างได้นับครับแล้วก็ต่อยกันมันมากครับผม
I am very confident because I think that we are both doing very good.
Yeah, were you surprised by anything in there? He didn't give you the space to unleash your best weapons, which was those hands, but he had a beautiful game plan. Were you surprised by anything in here tonight?
ก็วันนี้มีอะไรที่แปลกใจกับการวางแผนของคู่ต่อสู้ของเรามาหรือเปล่าครับในวันนี
้คือว่าออกแข้งครับเขาออกมาเข่าดีเหมือนกันนะเพราะว่าเราโดนแข้งก่อนพลาดโดนแข้งโดนนับก่อนครับครับผมไฟนอลก็จะทำให้ดีวันนี้ครับเพราะว่าเราก็กลับขึ้นมาต่อยนับได้หนึ่งครั้งครับผม
I'm a little bit surprised because he has a very good use of his leg and his knee, but I will do my best on the next fight.
But I have a surprise for you as well. How about a 350,000 baht bonus from Chatri Siddhartong, the CEO of ONE Championship? Great job.
เงินรางวัล 350,000 บาทครับผมจากคุณชาตรีสิทธิ์ยอดทอง
Both are winners here tonight.Great fight! Can't wait to see you both back here inside ONE Championship.
ก็เดี๋ยวขอให้เราจะกลับมาเจอกันอีกสักครั้งหนึ่งนะครับผมว่าตอนนี้ความรู้สึกเป็นไงบ้างครับ
ตอนนี้ก็ดีใจครับขอบคุณบอสชาตรีมากครับที่มอบเงินรางวัล
สาม
แสนห้าหมื่นให้กับผมครั้งนี้ครับขอบคุณมากครับผม
Yes, I feel very happy to have this opportunity. I want to thank Khunsuk and Saenchai to give me the bonus of 350,000 baht.
Good job. Double bonus for you two warriors here tonight in the main event at One Friday Fights. Ladies and gentlemen, please make some noise for your winner, Superball Tded99.
Kongklai Annymuaythai doesn't get the nod, but picks up a 350,000 baht bonus from the chairman, Chatri Sitchotong. The winner tonight, Superball Tded99, picks up as well a 350,000 baht bonus. Big win for the man, huge main event victory. The fight of the night, as we know, goes to Superball versus Kongklai. Back and forth all three rounds. What a battle it was. Kongklai with a knockdown of his own. But Superball was able to find the victory here. Denying Kongklai the use of his power with the clinch. Big elbows, piercing elbows. Good work to pressure Kongklai. What a victory and what a fight by Superball Tded99 and Kongklai Annymuaythai. That this fight, this main event, with just the Monster Energy fight of the night.
So many great fights. What an epic night here again at Lumpinee Stadium on One Friday Fights for One Championship. I'm Mitch Chilson. That was Diadi Suba, and we can't wait to see you next time on One Friday Fights.